Rockford Studios, live, baby! Start off with a little Iron Man by fucking Ozzy. But tonight, you know, we're going to be talking some good topics. We're going to be talking Gibson. We're going to be talking James Hetfield. And then we're always going to be doing the same thing that we always do, just shooting the shit and having a good time. So, you know, tonight we got our special guest, Garguts and Tomato. Let's bring them on in here, baby.
So,
what up, boys? What up?
You're in the headlights, look. I'm not trying to.
Oh, shit. I'm not here.
I'm
not ready.
I wasn't ready.
I was trying to look at the chat. I'm looking at the chat, guys. It's not like Mankind.
Nice. How's you guys' nights going?
I just got out of work, so yeah.
And I just started my night with this. Is my third beer.
Oh, damn. Okay.
My second one about to be.
I mean, it's Saturday. It's Saturday.
Yeah, I mean, Saturday.
So, I mean, hey, you know, it's okay to be, you know, getting a little drinky on, drink responsibly, drink overage.
How was your night? I mean, you work today?
Oh, yeah.
Today was Saturday. Today's my day off, so it was a nice, chill, relaxing day, but my dog's been sick, so I've just been taking care of her. Before the show, you were seeing me feed her just like deli meat. That's all she can eat right now. What?
Did you hear that?
What was it? Was it like a? I heard kind of like a tap or something. Like, was it like a bang on your guys' end? We're getting some paranormal activity going on, guys.
It was like I think it was a flat tire.
No, it's something with beer candy. Nah, hell no. Where are you going?
Well, it's a good thing we got this on video going live right now. Something's happening over in Garguts' house. Well, Garguts' guest's house.
Is that a beer can? It sounds like someone will throw it through an empty beer can.
It sounds like a fucking flat tire.
Nah.
Hey, man, maybe someone was being rude and they just littered. Just like, screw your house. I see you live streaming. Screw it.
Fuck your couch.
Honestly, it's not like that or somebody fucking had a flat tire or something.
Today's topics, baby. Let's start off with the first one. God, good.
Gibson.
All this nice setup.
Are you?
That thunder.
Gibson fan? Do you know Gibson guitars?
I've not really dealt with Gibson. I'm the only one in my family that doesn't play instruments.
Hey, can you hear us okay? Or do we need to turn up?
No, you're good.
Can you hear him when he talks?
Sounds pretty good. Let's check out the comments. Someone's in the chat.
Can you hear the air conditioner?
Quentin James, hey, man. What's up with Gibson? I do not hear the air conditioner at all. Quentin James, right? What is up with Gibson? That's what we're here to talk about. You just came right in time, man. We're about to talk about that right now.
The Gibson company?
Yeah.
You know, the big guitar company. Here. Give me one second. I just come back here.
Got the chat going on right here. Oh, okay. But no, so I don't really have. I know history. Not really too much history, but
we're talking Gibson. We're talking Gibson.
Ooh, is that a Les Paul?
Yes, it is, baby.
Les Paul Gibson.
Gibson Les Paul.
Oh God, yep. Dude, that's sexy guitar. God,
that guitar is probably. That guitar is like three guitars. That guitar is a fucking car payment.
Yeah, dude, Les Pauls are not.
It can be a car. Yes, it can be. Now, this guitar is a true guitar. It's a car payment, though.
Yeah, that's the true guitar.
That is so
this
nice.
This is my Vola.
Dude,
you got to show you, Tomato.
I know you told the story a million times, but you gotta tell them how that became yours.
Oh, now I gotta hear about this.
All right, Tomato. Yeah, it's a good story too. So sorry guys, before we get into the Gibson. So how I got the Vola is I go down to NAMM, which is a giant music trade show convention down in LA for, you know, us big wigs in the industry and stuff like that. I'm not really a big wig, but I'm making my way into the industry and stuff. So they do raffles and stuff for a bunch of gear. It's where everyone shows off their new gear for the new year and stuff. And there's a raffle where you had to show up to be there and stuff. Two people's numbers got called, and then my number got called, and I took home a guitar from LA. So I was like, okay, I'll take it.
Did you drive up there, or did you fly?
Nice.
I flew. So I had to pay for the checked bags back. It was like $100. $100 because I had it was $100 with my other checked bag too. So it was like $50 for each bag. Oh, yeah, okay. So DR Guitars is saying that he only has 6 Gibbies, 3 Les Pauls, 2 SGs, and a Firebird.
And a pear tree.
You know, it's not like I only got one.
You know, but I only got none. I got one guitar. I got one guitar, but hopefully my collection will get better in the next year.
Quentin has an Epiphone Explorer with gold hardware. That's why Hack unfriended me.
Not like oh, wait.
And friendly. Right. I'm sorry.
I have 2 guitars. I just retired the first one.
But yeah, so we're going to be talking about Gibson. Gibson's kind of, for Tomato, they're the big guitar company, you know, one of the biggest ones. There's Fender and Gibson.
That much I do know. But if you ask me any history about it, I wouldn't be able to tell you. But I do know
lately, it's not really news. It's just all of us YouTubers have been. It's everyone in the news of YouTube, basically, has been saying that, you know, Gibson, if you go and check their YouTube and stuff like that, all of their videos are just gone.
Yeah, I know, it's so weird. That's weird.
Yeah. Like, it doesn't make any sense to why
maybe you just take down all of these.
Because they're great content. It's good videos and stuff. Like, they're good videos.
Maybe they got copyrighted for an intro or something that they always use.
Yeah, you see. Okay, so this is what I liked. There's this guy named Trogly and stuff. Trogly's Guitar Show. He does a lot about Gibson guitars and stuff. And he's talking more, like, I kind of see it maybe that Gibson's kind of maybe using it so they can start copyrighting all their music and that they have in their videos. And stuff. So they're taking it down right now. So people aren't, because you know what happened with, because so what happened was there was the Play Authentic video.
Okay.
Where they basically said that they were going to go after all other companies that are kind of like, look like Gibsons and stuff like that. Like, you want to play authentic, like.
Hold on. What about fucking Epiphone?
Well, Epiphone is under Gibson. Gibson owns Epiphone.
Oh, they bought them back? Because I thought it was like... I thought they were a split company at first. No, I guess not.
Nope. So, there's that whole Play Authentic thing. And there was the whole thing about when they put it up and then they took it down immediately. But there's a bunch of people that republished it and reposted it.
What if it has to do with like this whole checkmark shit too?
What? What's that?
Like YouTube was taking away check marks from people that didn't acquire meet the standards anymore because they moved the standards higher. Just like Super Chat, like when or going live. When we used to be able to go live anytime, or we used on the phone, mobile, or when we used to Super Chat was available for like lower tiers. Now you have to be higher.
Well, monetization used to be only 100 subscribers.
Bro, I think out of all the times in YouTube, like, there was even monetized, and then there was ads, and then they want to put ads on my shit. And then they bought out my Google account. Like, Google bought out YouTube and put my Google account on YouTube. And then it's so much shit, it just keeps switching me over and over, and I'm just like, man, I'm not making any subscribers. I'm just like, I don't give a fuck. It'd be cool, but whatever.
Yeah, but Dave's saying Trogly. Or Austin is his real name. He's a knowledgeable guy. He knows a lot about Gibson, you know? And then Gibson bought Epiphone back in the late 50s and owned it ever since.
That's what it is. Okay. So that's, I remember hearing that they fucking, they were like homies, and then they said, nope.
No, Gibson bought Epiphone back in the late 50s and has owned it ever since.
Damn.
They used to be separate back in the 50s, like back in the early 50s and stuff like that.
I remember hearing about like a lot of this. I don't even remember the fucking YouTubers who did it, but there was like help for information back in like 2008 about, or 2012, about this kind of guitar stuff. Well, Quinn and James just said hack unfriended him. That's funny.
He said that it was because he has an Epiphone Explorer and not, and hacks all about Gibson.
That's funny.
So my brother had a BC Ridge Warlock. It didn't look like that exactly. It was red those designs, it was all white.
Bro.
Red.
Bro, show them.
But talking about BC Ridge?
But look at the...
We're talking about Rich Bitch?
But show him the thing.
I know the Warlocks, baby.
See, my brother had one. It was red. It was red, but those designs that are red on this picture, I don't know if I'm showing this right. My brother's design, it was white. The designs were white, but my brother's guitar was red.
Okay, so it was a red guitar with a white fire.
He had one of those. He still has it too. The coffin case.
That was that year when they did come with the coffin.
Because they had a Warlock guitar, and they also had the Warlock bass, too.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And they always come in coffin cases.
And it's so funny, too, because, like, 3 years later, my brother transitions from guitar.
Chicken guitars!
What up, chicken guitars? What up? Hope you're doing well. Love your jam. I need to fucking record mine soon.
I don't care. No one cares what you says, chicken guitars. You can critique yourself all you want. We all love it.
Hey, no, but like I said, or like you said, you fucking love that she critiques herself right there and then. So, I think I might have to take a page out of my playbook, chicken guitars, and but it's make a spin on my own.
While we do this, I'll be right back. I'm not grabbing ice, but I'm grabbing some food. My food is here. So,
bro, get your food, man.
I'm gonna go grab that real quick. Garguts of them will entertain the masses.
Garguts tomato right here.
What's going on?
You have a coffin case for your Mockingbird Doctor guitars?
That's dude, badass.
Coffin cases are awesome, dude. Like,
bro,
when I saw that the first time, dude, I was like, dude, this is a Halloween prop and a fucking guitar, dude,
right?
And a guitar case.
I like the coffin case. Hey, but didn't they have one that looks like a modern day coffin too?
Yeah, I think
it opens up in two different ways.
Right? I think there was a double case coffin guitar.
Yeah, actually, so I remember seeing that.
It had
it had an old fashioned casket, and then if I'm not mistaken, I saw one next to it. It was white, but it was like a modern day looking casket.
Oh, that one! Yes. I think they did. What the fuck?
I believe they did too. I'm not sure. I saw it in a magazine.
I was like 11, about to be 12, man.
So I mean, I'm 27 now. I'm
just I was probably like fucking 15, and I was just like, "What the fuck is that bullshit?" Oh shit, my shit's.
Oh, did we?
No, we're still on.
Okay.
My shit's just. Likes to turn off when I don't fucking finger it. We're back, Ruby. Oh shit! I just grabbed a fucking roach.
Yeah, they that is the downfall about living here. No, they tend to be the roaches. I have something that can take care of the roaches. It's a little gel, actually. What the is that?
Well, I mean, it was water.
Oh, okay. So you were drinking out of it.
Yeah.
But no, so Millhouse, actually, I had the luxury of seeing my mom's bass. Funny story about that. Actually, you know what? I'll wait till your Frankie's back. Because it's funny, because he mentioned a story about his guitar.
Yeah.
I actually would really appreciate it if you heard the story about mom's bass.
Oh, your mom's bass?
Yeah. My dude, I'm the only one that came out that didn't play. My brother's instrumentalist, actually. Okay. You had him an instrument and played it 2 weeks.
Okay.
Well, mastered in 2 weeks.
I'm pretty much the same. I mean, not that way, but like, yeah.
Like, go master in 2 weeks. Like, that's no joke, bro. Like, master that shit in 2 weeks.
Man, I wish you would, like.
I know. I don't know how much that is in whole actually. I have a hook right there too, and I don't know why. It's just not been used ever.
Wow. You might have had
I don't know.
Another. They might have fucking put another thing right there. It wasn't.
Anyways, we're all boring over here. We're just talking shit.
I'll wait till your friend gets back and tell him sort of my face. It's kind of funny. Yes. He's seen it. My roommate.
Oh, so you did see the coffin case.
So I wasn't wrong about that coffin case, was I? Like, it was like a modern day
casket? Aftermarket. It isn't as good as the old school coffin case. Yeah, it probably isn't, because it's like.
But does it open up in two ways, or?
Yeah, does it open up in two ways, or does it just do one fucking thing?
But it kind of looks cool, and don't get me wrong. I'm just a little curious.
Was it velvet? On the inside, because that would be fucking crazy.
That would be actually cool. But no, I mean, still, yeah. Because I know it wasn't crazy. Like, I could have swore I saw a modern day casket as a guitar case instead of just the old fashioned. Which I'm glad I really got the old fashioned one.
I'm back.
What's up?
Hey, so if I got the okay. You know how you told me the story about how you got your guitar?
Mm-hmm.
Would you like to hear how my mom got a bass guitar?
Sure. Of course.
All right. So she started playing bass when she was like 16. So she played bass her whole life. You know, she started playing bass, this and that. The only reason she wanted to play bass is so she could audition in front of the Rolling Stones. Long story.
Okay.
But she.
That's a long story that I kind of want to. Did she ever get to?
We'll talk about that a different time.
Okay.
However, I think if I'm not mistaken, her bass, her purple bass, it's purple by the way, is a Gibson. If I'm not mistaken. So she got this the paint job for free. The kind of purple that it was like a specific purple. And Osaka, Japan gave her the paint job for free because at that time, Prince was the king of purple. So that being said, my mom got that paint job for free because they thought, Japan thought this was a member of the band Prince.
Huh? Shit, what?
Yes, so she got this specific purple.
In Japan when she was...
No, it got from Japan.
Okay.
She got it from Japan because at that time Prince was the king of purple. So
yeah, it was.
Yeah.
It still is. And
purple rain.
It just so happens that specific purple is the purple that he was known for. So like my mom got that paint job for free actually. And it's a really beautiful bass, actually. Like, oh my god. Like,
do you have a picture of it?
I do not.
Do you know what model it is?
I just know that it's purple. It's beautiful. He's seen it.
Do you know like, what brand it is?
I want to say it could be a Gibson. I doubt it though. It could be though. I don't know what brand.
Yeah, Gibson doesn't make basses. I don't think so.
Oh, okay. So they don't.
I was gonna say if it is.
It's probably a Fender though.
What is it? Epiphone? Is that a brand? Epiphone?
Yeah, it might be. I mean, I don't know if Epiphone makes a bass, but I'm pretty sure they do.
Either way, it's.
But I'm just saying, in 1980, so
that's true.
That's
okay. So Dave does say Gibson makes basses. So okay, I'm wrong.
I've seen a Gibson with the four peg. That's about it.
Rick Effner, how's your night going? Sorry, I don't want everyone to just like watch me eat.
What up, Rick? Oh, no, dude. Fucking munch out, dude. You good.
Yeah, we're entertaining the crowd, I guess, so to speak. I know that's not boring, but yeah.
You're so boring, tomato.
That's why they call me tomato.
Boring. more about Tomato Beer. He's a referee for the company that I work for. I know I told Alex this, but I'm just telling the chat. We work for Heavy Metal Wrestling. You know what I'm saying?
Doing good, Rick. Doing good.
Dude, our fucking intro used to be, what was it? It was
30 minutes to midnight.
Yeah, dude.
Nice.
By Paxton.
Yeah.
We had nothing but Saxton songs, dude. We use them.
Okay, so what I don't get is, why don't we have a live band anymore? Do you know anything about that?
Because that shit is so difficult between... Because you need me, okay? I'm an all-around musician. These lovers y'all were getting were just playing punk music. And I'm
I mean, one of them just had... One of the good ones, actually, is Dunbar's friend. He was actually there during training one day when we were training at the dojo, at Mackie's dojo. So he had his friend there, and then like years later, I see him playing, and I was like, "Hey, I know you." He's like, "Yeah."
Oh, so he did train?
No, he didn't. I trained, yes.
Okay, so I'm totally wrong. Gibson makes a bunch of noises.
He was just there visiting because I guess him and Dunbar were gonna hang out later if they. I mean, again.
Oh, I'm stupid. I should know that. Mickey Six plays a fucking Gibson bass.
Wait, who plays a Gibson? EB series, Thunder basses.
Nikki Six.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, can you actually see us, by the way? We can't see you.
Yeah, I can see you guys. I have my camera off just for the moment while I'm eating.
Oh, okay. But you can see us, though?
Yeah, I can see you guys fine.
Where'd you get that? Pastrami on rye?
Sandwich? No, it's just some pizza.
No,
it's just some Mountain Mike's.
You stirring macaroni over there.
Oh, God. But, yeah, so what's up with this old Gibson, you know? I mean,
yeah,
I'm kind of feeling like the whole thing. It's like maybe they're going for the whole, like, you know, protect their copyright.
We just got two theories going on right now. Either they got copyrighted or they want a copyright.
But why would they take on
our Well,
because it takes a process of 24 to fucking week and a half.
Okay.
I think that's what they're doing. And then if not, maybe Gibson got bought out. Who knows?
No, Gibson definitely didn't get bought out.
All right, cool. Yeah, that'll probably be the first news. It's got to be something
with the news. So.
That they're changing.
Today is Saturday, and so yesterday we had Phil McKnight's live show going on, and he was talking about how he got an email from someone that's kind of the know, but knows something, but we don't know it. I don't think it's probably true, because they're saying that Mark Agnesi might be fired, which is probably not true, saying Mark Agnesi went on and posted on his Instagram with the fucking, the slapping your hand to your forehead emoji.
Oh, yeah.
And stuff. He just had that posted to each time, like, every person was talking about Mark Agnesi. So, clearly, he's not fired. So, that's what everyone was trying to say he was.
I think there's something just changed in the company. If he's not fired, somebody's...
Yeah, Nick Six used to play Gibson. Now he's endorsed by someone else.
Oh, shit. Well, wait. Gibson, wait. Is he a company member? A board member or something?
Who?
Mark?
Mark Agnesi is like the head, is like the social media head of social media marketing.
So you think he got fired?
That's what everyone was, like, speculating with the whole Gibson taking down all their videos. But then he goes on his Instagram and posts all, like, to, like, respond to all these, like, videos of everyone saying this with the emoji of with the slapping of the forehead.
I mean, I just think it's something on the inside. It's very small, minuscule, and it's probably just they're switching their fucking formula around to get probably more money out of YouTube somehow.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think Mark Agnesi is going anywhere. I think YouTube's just going to bring back their videos at some point. They're doing something with them. They just needed to take them down. I think, yeah. I think it's the whole copyright thing, just making sure all their songs and all this, when people are playing, like, their guitars and stuff, all of that gets copyrighted and stuff, so people don't go off and republish videos if they take them down, like they did with the Play Authentic video.
And you know, sometimes it's good to take down your videos and then bring them back because it brings more traffic. And it fucking tricks the algorithm into saying, hey, maybe they're fucking doing new thumbnails and shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? You gotta trick the algorithm somehow to fucking get your shit more out of
there. Yeah, but that was the other issue. It was just like, their YouTube was okay. It wasn't that great. It was okay, you know? It just seemed like their thumbnails were just being used, as you can tell, is just whatever YouTube suggests. And then, yeah, it's like, they don't have, like, complete playthroughs of each guitar. They have, like, good sections of, like, listens, and you can hear the guitar, but not, like, complete playthroughs of the full guitar, you know? Mm-hmm. And that's coming from, like, Gibson themselves, where they probably should have that, you know?
Yes,
this is nothing yet. No. It was just the last question was about Nikki Six.
Oh, okay.
Excuse me,
yeah,
it's endorsed by
Schecter. Nick Six may be endorsed by Schecter. I don't remember who's endorsed by now.
He's probably endorsed by drugs.
Well, I don't know about that.
I mean, you've seen the fucking behind the fucking music. Oh, remember that show? That was one.
I watched The Dirt.
Well, I have. I did watch.
See, my real dad actually has a book, by the way. My Motley Crue with The Dirt.
Really?
Yeah, he actually had, like, still mm-hmm. had. Well, he had it. I mean, I don't
That's
know.
That's a good
that.
Book.
I never read it. Sadly, it got ruined. Actually. Split up.
Well, they're not that expensive on Amazon.
Like a plastic bag. But either way, I heard it's a good book.
I fucking read the book more than I watch that movie right now.
Yeah, I heard the book actually goes further than the movie, though.
Of course it does, because you can only put so much on Netflix. I mean, SJW flicks. I mean,
or
Netflix.
Even in a movie, in general.
Yeah, that's true.
It's true, yeah. It's just how long can you have to entertain
all together.
And you're going to get more of the truth in the book rather than where the movie is more going to be for entertainment.
Or in an interview.
It's true, actually.
When they're drunk, you've been there, Alex.
With oh, yeah. Oh, that was a good night.
So I was telling him some stories, bro. Like, I was like, and it's funny because I was like, I know this story.
He'll show you after this.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good book. Dave reads it. Dion Guitars reads the book, The Dirt. Yeah, it's a really good book.
Any word from Jell or Fierce?
Nothing yet. I just told Fierce to hop on whenever. Oh, wait. Fierce is tired tonight. He's not going to be able to be available tonight, so no worries.
Oh, good. I hope he's watching. Probably not. He's on another stream. He left us for another stream.
No, he's probably either here. He's asleep. I mean, hey.
Oh, yeah, he's probably asleep already.
That's what he was telling me. He's pretty tired. And I mean, I don't blame him. We've kept him up pretty late most nights.
Yeah, we kept him pretty late. Man, dude, so this whole Jamz Hetfield, you want to get into that?
All right, yeah, let's get into Jamz Hetfield, man. Yeah, man, let's talk about Metallica and Jamz Hetfield.
Have you ever seen Metallica?
Yes, I've seen Metallica live, yes.
Once, twice, three, four?
Okay, so here's a good story. I'm going to come back for this one, too. Look, I'm back, baby!
What up?
So, yeah, okay, Metallica. The first story, excuse me. I've seen them live, and I saw them for the halftime when they were doing the whole thing, when they were got the whole, you know, change.org for the giant petition for them to play halftime show and stuff like that, when it was down in the Bay Area in San Francisco, their hometown. Like, it should have been Metallica that played that halftime.
When was that?
Yeah, like either 2015 or 2016. I can't remember. I would have to look at one of my pieces of memorabilia, but I just don't know. It's in a different box.
All right, cool.
If you ever have a rock and roll book to recommend, let a sister know. Chicken Guitar says. But you still hear me, my guy?
Dude, it seems hot in here, dude.
It does, but it seems, I don't know, I guess that's just a brand of that fucking
thing. I really hope the Freon can go out. That would, man.
It looks like it's fucking going back down and down. It's just taking forever.
So AJ, yeah. So the first time, yeah, I've seen them. It was the night before halftime. So the night before the Super Bowl that they had down in San Francisco.
Badass.
Which is way, that? It's way better. Yeah, way better than, huh?
Were they play a 3-hour set?
Oh yeah, it was a fat. It was just Cage the Elephant opened for them, and then it was just them.
They
played a 2-hour set.
Okay, and then they do like an intermission, right?
No, yeah. They didn't do an intermission. They just did a fat encore.
Fuck!
What? Wow.
I've only been to one fat encore before, and that was Seven Dust. And I was lost.
Oh, damn.
There we go.
I'm sorry. Really? I'm sorry.
Okay. Yeah, I was just like, so they're not getting off stage?
So that's the first time, you know, normal just paying tickets to see them. You know, man, the second time I saw them, they came to my work, actually.
But
music venue for where I used to work in SF.
Well, were they eating there?
Huh?
What were they doing at your work?
Well, they were doing the charity event, the All Hands for Benefit charity, or whatever it is that they do.
Oh, so you got closer to them.
It's the charity event. It's like the charity tour and stuff. No, so I didn't get to meet them, but I was working maintenance that day, and right before I left, they were all, like, right, I was told, like, when I work maintenance, you get lunch and stuff like that, and this was a day that was super busy, so they would just give us, like, the meal ticket for our catering down that we have, that they would give for, like, the artists and other, like, the stage crew and stuff like that, and when we went down there, me and my buddy, all of Metallica's in there.
And I bet you walked in and you're just like, do we walk back
out? Oh, we walk in and we had to immediately walk out. we're not allowed in. We're not allowed. Yeah, they don't. Because here's the thing. Just being me, like, I have a fucking Metallica blanket right here. Like, you know.
Yeah.
Metallica's been a big thing in my life, so literally to go and walk into the same room as, like, the dudes I looked up to when I was 5, 6, 7 and stuff, and if I talked, and me knowing me, I'm like, if I go in there, I'm gonna just fucking be a girl and fucking fangirl out, you know? Like, I have to be professional at this job, you know? That's the whole point of working at a music venue. You have to be, gotta be professional. You can't be all, like, fan, gooey, you know? Whoop, did you guys freeze?
No, we're listening to your story.
Yeah,
I'm like,
we're listening, man.
Oh, it was a little, okay.
I'm getting into it, I'm just like, what else happened?
I had to walk out and stuff because I was just like, I can't.
Did the hostess or the...
It was like,
how did you do that?
Huh?
I don't know. No, they probably just know already. There was no, like, there was no official... Because when you walk in those things, you have to have badges. So you walk in that fucking thing.
Yeah, so, okay, so here's the... and then where this was, so how my, like, old venue used to be laid out is, like, multiple floor... is actually multiple floors and stuff. So we're actually a floor down below the stage and stuff.
Okay.
Because it's not just a music venue. It's actually a Freemason's temple. Yeah. Woo-loo-loo, motherfuckers.
What I tell you?
I know.
Yeah.
That's why shit is
Anthony
up.
Hagen. Earth is 3 weeks spewing.
Right before we go to this, Freemason.
All right.
They're not bad people.
Yo, Anthony, what you mean by that, my friend?
My uncle was.
Perth. Yo, you got. Hey, do you see this? What the fuck's that mean in the chat?
Ironically, now you know.
Yo, Gargots.
Yeah.
See that chat? What's?
No, I'm looking at it.
Fuck's that?
Wait, what? Look
here. Yeah.
What is that? What you mean, man?
Heard this 3 weeks viewing.
Yeah. What does that mean? Right? No clue. But yeah, so. Yeah. Okay. But I got to see their sound check of that night and stuff, and it was really good.
So, Jamz is just drinking, but it probably might be coke. Answering to Rick over here. Because, I mean, when you drink, you do coke, man. And that was my vice. Oh, I'm saying that was my vice. When you go out there.
Ah, okay, Anthony, yeah. Massive fan, mate. It's announced.
I'm not saying Perth.
Okay.
No, I'm just saying.
Rick, that's a good question. That's
what we're saying.
Here's the thing, because he's going back to rehab, and they specifically say it's again, like he's going back for something that he's gone to rehab before. And I remember he went to rehab specifically for alcohol.
I would think it's for alcohol, but then again, I didn't see him. Maybe I didn't see him. Okay, so one day, I was downtown drinking at my local bar.
Oh, we're sorry. And, we're gonna get a real life story going.
And I get a text saying, "Hey, Jamz Hetfield is down here at this is the day before they fucking played at the Alamo Dome." So I get a text saying, "Hey, Jamz Hetfield just showed up to Charlie Wants a Burger," and I was just like, "I am literally a block away. Why the fuck not?"
So I get you, Anthony. Now I get you.
Oh, now I'm getting an echo.
But you resigned?
So, okay, so I went down to Charlie Wants a Burger, mm-hmm. and Jamz was upstairs. He had the entire upstairs restaurant closed down just for him and his friend. It was like 30 people just in a fucking they were in a circle. You could see it on the camera because I went to the kitchen and I was like, "Holy shit, that's Jamz Hetfield," because I could see it. And then I was like, "You know what? I've been drinking down here. It's time to take a piss." So I go take a piss. And I'm like hoping that he needs to take a piss because
you're not stuck in the bathroom. Just like,
I'm always.
Oh shit! Walked in. All right, my turn.
Funny thing is, I met Michelangelo Basio in the bathroom taking a piss. I met Jake the Snake Roberts taking a piss. They're piss next. I'm taking a piss, and they fucking walk in, and they just take a piss next to me. I'm like, oh, I was gonna be a dumb
guy. Kind of funny. It's kind of funny you said that. I was at a BOW show, and Charlie Haas just lost the belt to, but he just lost the BOW title, and he was in the shower in that, because it was in a church. It was a church further up here. I can show you the church. So he just lost the belt, all right? He really just lost, he lost the belt, and he was taking a shower in that, so I
put it in there.
And I walked into the restroom, he was shaving, he looked at me, and I looked at him, because he already knew I was the only one that was cheering for him. I really was. He actually called me out, and I felt like someone told me, "Hey, don't do that again because you look like you are Martin." Like,
too much of a fangirl, dude. Don't be a fangirl.
Well, at the time, I was barely starting to train, so like I didn't know yet.
So what do you do? If he said, "Hey, you want to shave my balls or what?"
No. I was jumping up and down.
Oh, jeez.
This guy who has long hair jumping up and down like a young Shawn Michaels. I'm like, oh, jeez, okay. And like he called me out in front of everybody. I felt like such a dick. And then afterwards, I see him in the bathroom, like getting ready to shower, actually, because that place didn't have a shower. Because the piece was going
right. Okay. So,
and I went to the restroom, and I just see him like shaving. He looked at me, I looked at him, I'm like, I did that.
Sign of respect.
Yeah, I mean, like.
So that's what I was hoping to do with, like, get the sign of respect. But I walked upstairs, and he's drinking with his friend. They're just standing there like this, and they're watching. This is the night of San Francisco, the Warriors versus where the fuck they were playing.
Probably Cleveland. When was it?
2017.
Yeah, Cleveland.
So. he was upstairs and he was drinking with his friend. I don't even know if they probably had like a few beers. They didn't have much. It wasn't like party. That's why I'm just surprised. Like when I saw him, he wasn't drinking much. It was just like whatever. It was just like little bits of beer here and
there. Well, that's the thing. Back in like 2015 and stuff, he gets a tattoo of a razor blade on him and he calls himself a born again straight edge.
So this is 2017, so I could see the progression mm-hmm. of a little bit of fucking beer. Then it was even a lot. It was just like a little fucking pan.
Well, yeah, don't get me wrong. Like if you there's a thing of called drinking in moderation. Like don't there's you can do it. And, it's not an issue.
Every time the Warriors scored, he did the thing. He said, "Yeah, yeah." He was high-fiving his buddy, and I was like, "Holy shit, this is
James." Well, you gotta think about it. When it comes to that, you gotta think about it. He's a Bay Area native and stuff. All of Metallica is—they're all Bay Area natives and stuff like that.
Well, I mean,
and except for like, the Warriors have been there since they were little and stuff like that. So, like the Warriors is probably James Hetfield's favorite basketball team. That makes sense. Don't get me wrong. Like that's how I feel right now about the Niners, man. Like, damn. Good.
But to hear him say the famous thing that he always says,
yeah,
and I was just, that's James Hetfield right there. That's great. I took pictures of him and put him on my fucking Facebook, but I shared the whole thing. I didn't take a picture with him. I was just like, dude, James Hetfield's right next to me. What the fuck? I had to do it.
So Anthony, I'm guessing that they're going to be hoping that James Hetfield will be okay and be out of rehab by Brazil's next, by the next year Brazil tour. So
I mean, I think that's why he went. He checked in right now because of business.
Yeah, he probably did himself like that. He was like, if I just do this and if I get it done now, it's rather if I get help now, then it'll be better for later on and for the long run. So that's why, yeah. And that's why, here's the thing, I'm a big Metallica fan. We're not talking shit about him. We really do wish the man the best of luck and stuff like that. Like, no, we really do wish the man well. But we're just here, like, it's news. It's something that's happening now. We gotta, let's talk about it, Like, let's talk about, Metallica in general.
Dude, your fucking internet connection looks fantastic now.
Is it way better? Yeah. How's it out there in the chat, guys? My way here looking better out?
More louder and more clear now, actually.
Like I just turned it up right now, but yeah, you know I'm saying like you before it looked like 144p. Like you know what I'm saying?
Like a few days ago?
Yeah, a few days ago. That was fucking fast. But your audio always sounded good.
Yeah, I always got the audio sounding good. Always.
Yeah, you got that microphone right there.
That's what mattered more. Yeah, I got the microphone going, and then with the direct guitar. So.
What kind of microphone is that?
It's an Audio Technica AT2020.
Okay, is that the one they use for like those like weird sound people? The people that do the weird sound, or like they're talking to the microphone, and then you can like it sound like they're behind your ear. So you know what I'm talking about?
Like you would hear like the what do you mean? Like what do you mean?
Okay, so like. They can be in like on the side of the microphone, and if you have headphones on, it sounds like they're in the back, like they're like right behind your ear talking.
Oh, so that's all like post, like that's all like post processing, like moving it left and right and stuff like that.
Okay,
they do have stereo mics and stuff like that do that, but it's basically two microphones.
Oh, okay, like.
But, right. Well, like, this one, it's really easy to hear me from, like, really far away and stuff, and I don't have to talk as loud. Like, I can still be here from this far. But then I have... I have this mic right here and stuff, and I have to be, like, right here all up on the mic and stuff so it can hear me.
Oh, okay.
So that's, like, the biggest difference and stuff. And then clarity, really.
Yeah, that's true, too.
So, but
you know what I'm talking about, those microphones, right? Like the sounds like they're right behind your ear.
Okay, great question.
Yeah, so,
like the ones that go, like the ones that like will go right behind your ear and stuff.
No, like you can talk to it like this, but it's like if and if you're wearing headphones, it mm-hmm. sounds like they're right behind you, like right behind your ear. It sounds like they're right behind your ear. Like the person talking in the microphone in front of you, but it just sounds like they're right behind your ear.
Yeah.
I mean, you know what I'm talking about, man.
Yeah. I don't know what the mic would be called, to be honest.
Oh, okay. Okay.
But yeah, and then you know Metallica, man. Yeah, who doesn't know Metallica? There's no doubt the biggest band in the world, Anthony says.
I'm not the biggest Metallica fan. I like some of their songs. Mm-hmm. There's actually a playlist that I like of them. And I'm not a bit of naming songs, and I know if I hear it, I'm like, okay.
Bro, you fucking had tickets to the fucking one. You didn't give me any.
Oh, dude, no. When I got those tickets, bro. When I got those tickets. That show.
Jesus, you didn't take me, bitch.
You didn't even take me.
Yeah, no, you saw those tickets on the
floor. Yeah, I was like, what the fuck are these? Basketball tickets?
Yeah, no. Like, okay, so I had tickets to go see the wall, right?
Okay, yeah.
My roommate gave me tickets to the wall the day after the show.
He knew.
Like in the wrestling business, I was like, man, is this a rib?
Yeah, it probably is.
I was like, man, is that a rib, dude? Like, come on, dude. Come on, bro.
Nah, dude. In music, come on, dude, bro. It's just the completely.
Fuck! I was like, dude, is this a fucking rib, man?
Yeah.
Like, oh, I'll give him shit when I wake up. Was that a rib? By the way,
did you do that for an April Fool's joke? Because it was in July, bro. And that was way after.
She was like, oh my god, the day after.
Anthony, if I had a guitar and standard tuning right now, I would.
Uh-oh. What were you saying, Anthony, what?
He said play hardwired intro and stuff, and I'm also looking at it, and I'm just like, it's not really... It's just a lot of just a... Like...
Hardwired... What's Hardwire intro?
So it's their new album, Hardwire. Hardwired Self-Destruct. The latest album that came back out with, like, what was it?
From who?
2016, 2017? Metallica.
Oh, the fucking old Metallica. Hey, I enjoyed that new Metallica-ish because at least Rob gave them some life.
Anthony is like, I can play like Jamz.
Whatever.
Oh, so you can do all that down picking and stuff? That down. Ah! Oh! Man.
Love it.
Say.
I mean, play like Jamz doesn't take too much effort, he just kind of down-pick a lot. Down-pick the drumming.
Like, if we're going to do, like, just sound weird because I'm going to have different
tempo. That's because I bent over.
See, I plug into Les Paul, but I still need
this real beer.
Don't blame it on the beer now.
I'm blaming it on the beer because I never fucking.
Oh yeah, no down picking. Now, Anthony, my favorite song to play.
Down picking.
Lots of down picking. That's the King, Jamz Hetfield, king of down picking, man. Just... He's king of down picking, but this Metallica song I love to play is fucking Am I Evil? If I can remember it. I can't remember it.
Hey, what? Oh, no, I'll talk to you about it after the stream. I don't know what I'm talking about.
Can you do okay, what was one of Metallica's like favorite, like not favorite, just like obscure songs that you ever heard from Metallica?
Well, that was one of them. That's Am I Evil. That's a
Am I Evil?
Am I Evil? You know, Am I Evil is a really obscure because it's also it's a you know it's a it's actually a cover. You know, of
somebody else. I know that.
Yeah,
that's why everybody fucking played it that one day on the fucking on the Big Four tour.
But yeah, and then
did you ever hear?
Yeah.
I'll tell you. Okay, well, name yours and I'll name mine.
Nah, go for it. Yeah, the Justice. Anthony says the Justice album is his like most obscure stuff that he kind of heard. The thing is, I just love a lot of Metallica. You know, it's.
I'll tell you one that probably not a lot of y'all. So. Not a lot of y'all have heard, and this is you know how Metallica did okay, this is one of them. Metallica made a song for Mission Impossible.
Really?
And it was called I just remember it goes bam 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 bam. Oh, Until I Disappear. That's what it was called.
Okay.
That was a real weird one for me because I was just like, wow, Metallica just their first ever kind of like original song.
I Disappear.
Yeah. And it had a good solo.
Anyone
it was just
into Iced Earth?
Wow, actually. I swear to God, the guy who did the Iron Maiden covers also did the artwork for Iced Earth.
If he has a webcam on, I might get a call from them to replace them.
Probably. Like, but the artwork looks the same, right?
The artwork does look the same.
Dude, like,
Iced Earth like, artwork looks like Judas Priest slash Iron Maiden artwork. To me.
What are we talking about? What are we talking about? There?
The artwork of Iron Iced Earth looks like Judas, like Iron Maiden artwork.
Oh, okay.
Like the same artist, like the same kind
of. Look up.
I haven't really heard of them. So.
The Egyptian album of Iced Earth, which is probably their second album, and then look up any Iron Maiden album. It, like the artwork, the lettering is the exact same. I swear to God.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Like,
we all know where Iced Earth came from was the guy with Judas Priest that took over for Rob when he was.
But did he have any connections with the guy?
Yes, because they did have to tour with each other.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure.
Therefore, I'm saying, like, if you look at it, like their second album, the Egyptian album, if you look at any other Iron Maiden album in general, they look exactly the same artwork and drawing the same lettering.
Anthony's asking where are we situated in the world. I'm in California, USA, and Garguts and his buddy Tomato are over in Texas, USA.
Hey, we've never actually met each other in fucking person, but we're fucking good friends. It's crazy.
Wait, so
have
never met each other alone?
No, we've never hung out at all. We're hoping to fucking hang out at them.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we met through this.
We met through YouTube.
Yeah, we met through YouTube on a live stream. Just talking.
Our opinions came together. We were like, bro, like you're so chill. I've had him on my channel. He's had me more on his channel because my channel is going down right now. I need a better computer. But I was actually gonna go live and be like, just hopping people in through StreamYard.
I'm always down for it if anyone wants to hop in, but yeah. Why are you not blazing that weed? Well,
because YouTube is a little fucking sketchy sometimes. That's why.
Sometimes it's a lot of the time.
Yeah.
YouTube don't like the marijuanas. So,
unless you're a marijuana channel.
I'm gonna be honest. If you guys were in Quentin James live streamer earlier, I think Rick was. I think he's the one that caught me and stuff. But you know, when I, sometimes when I turn,
I
know you do. But sometimes I'll turn on my banner. I'll say I'll be right back. I'm gonna go grab some ice. I do go do that usually. I usually go grab ice. That's what I do first. Then I come back and it's usually what I do right when I come back. I'm right behind the curtain behind me.
I'm on cue with them so that they go back to the apartment and come back.
Can you hear so, the
can you hear the honking outside?
Yeah.
Yeah, wow. These motherfuckers out there, they will open their car and forget their key, so they have to go back. Because I guess their car is like unlocked like infinitely. Like they don't have they don't have a so they know when somebody's fucking opening the car, so
they're supposed to go outside and like
right.
So right now they're probably running back to their car.
It's
like
so annoying.
Really it's okay, like so not I'm, that noticeable.
Okay. Metallica.
Why are a lot of people watching this? Like,
yeah.
Y'all shut that honking up. Yes.
Yeah.
Which I do.
Here, I'll go e Honda that car real quick. Street pride of that shit. I would say another Metallica song or like songs that I thought were really obscure were. And I don't know if anybody remembers this in the chat, but does anybody remember Spawn? Or do you remember Spawn, Alex?
Swan?
Spawn.
Spawn? Yeah, Spawn fucking... Oh, dude, grew up on Spawn, bro.
Yeah, bro, they need to make it. They need to remake
it. Well, they're remaking it. Right? They need to come out with
yeah, I thought Spawn. They were, yeah.
So Spawn, the entire soundtrack, was literally 85% Metallica.
Yeah.
Mixed with trance music, like industrial trance music.
Wow, that's
so if you listen to like the Spawn soundtrack, I'll be jamming that shit all the time. I'm like, dude, this Metallica bug right here, like it's fucking weird. It's obscure. I like it. Mm-hmm. And then that's where Korn also did. I think they did the PA, which they never played ever in their entire career. Already recorded for Spawn soundtrack. I was like, Metallica and Korn? Fuck yeah. Oh, and Butthole Surfers? Fuck.
But wow, I have not
Prodigy?
Heard that.
Prodigy? Yes.
It was I have
oh, yeah.
Butthole Surfers
fuck yeah.
In a long time.
It's a good fucking.
Yeah, my parents. I remember when I moved
wow.
out. So, like, when growing up, like my parents are
wow.
huge comic book fans and stuff like that. So,
oh, Spawn?
It's comic book. Just comic book fans and gems. Loads and loads of different comic books. We used to own a baseball card store too and stuff. So we used to have all like the Magic, Yu-Gi-Oh, Pokemon, and all the baseball
yeah.
cards. And then we had like a bunch of different.
My
and then both my parents were super into comics and mainly like X-Men, Spawn, fucking not some of like you know some of the other comics, but some of these obscure weird ones and shit. SM2
yeah.
is on the theaters around the world on the 9th of October.
So what happened? So you just wait. So that was by your house or your family owned it? What did you say?
Yeah, my family used to own it, like in my
that's
town.
That's crazy. They own a fucking comic book shop.
No, not
so
comic
like,
book shop. A card store.
Oh, a card store.
Yeah.
What? That's not too far. Dude, I love card stores, too.
Yeah,
because,
it was basically kind of the same thing, because now we have, like, a comic book shop that is the card store in town now.
There was a card store. Well, it wasn't this card store. It was the flea market.
Mm-hmm.
I used to go there and just buy... I used to fucking study what to fucking look at to buy a card. And it was like, you have to have crisp edges, you can't be fucking around this crap, don't fucking get this deck. This deck would be worth more because of financing, and I don't know
yep.
what the fuck, it was so stupid. I was
yeah, that's like the type of card store that we have now.
But I literally just said, I still have that book somewhere, but it's probably with my cards at my mom's house, and all my fucking cards are untouched, like I have so many fucking, like, I have probably about 3 or 4 fucking binders that are thick as fuck full of fucking cards. They were new school at the time, but now they're old school. So, they're probably a big,
right.
I mean, I could probably buy a Patrick Ewing and fucking sell it for $80. It's a rookie card, probably by now. Patrick Ewing's not even that fucking big. I mean, it's a big star, but
maybe a Vinny Del Negro or fucking Spur.
Yes.
Yeah, I used to collect a bunch of magic cards and Pokemon cards and stuff like that.
Oh, and I mean like baseball cards.
Oh yeah, hell yeah, but I don't have them anymore.
What about Yu-Gi-Oh?
Oh yeah, we used to do Yu-Gi-Oh is one of the big ones.
Yes, yes, aim. I'm gonna say, just saying.
I think he wants to challenge you.
I sadly don't have any more Yu-Gi-Oh decks. Those are all gone now. All I got is magic now. Yeah.
Really? My brother got it. Right. I don't get the idea of the concept. I remember Magic being really big in high school and trying to fucking figure that shit out. And I was like, yo, fuck this. I got Star Wars cards. Who wants to figure this shit out?
Dude, I remember those Star Wars cards.
Yeah, I had those and I lost them real quick. Dude, I used to walk into Scholastics with like $34 and buy all that shit. That's where I bought it from.
Oh yeah, from the fucking like Scholastics, and then dude, they used to do book fairs like that.
The book fair, that's what I'm talking about, the book fair, and they would have like card games that I've never heard of. There was no, like, I would go to, we have Alien Worlds down here, or like comic book stores. I was going to that shit, and there was nothing like that.
Right,
watch this, and I'm like, I don't give a shit. I'm going to learn this fucking thing.
How do we go from comic books to, oh yeah, we're talking about Metallica, and they're
Spawn. But no, if you like Spawn, dude, like, wait till the new one comes out. That's going to be boring.
Oh, I know, I can't wait for the new one to come out.
When I was a kid, I used to, what do you call it? I used to draw a Spawn fucking mask a lot.
Yeah.
And I made, I was in art, and they said, we're going to make a clay mold out of this. And I was like, the first thing I did was I made a Spawn clay mold, just this mask.
Nice.
And I tried to wear it, but it broke. You realize that the entire fucking Kill 'Em All album was made under alcohol.
Was it made under what?
Alcohol influence.
Oh, hell yeah.
So,
you know how many Grey albums were made under fucking drug and alcohol influence?
So like, I'm gonna...
That's the thing. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, I think that there is, yes, clean making and stuff like that, but there is a thing of moderation and there's stuff like that. I think there's certain things. Don't be sitting there to be doing like heroin and stuff before you fucking get into a session. That's fucked up, you know? But if you have a joint, maybe a beer or two, you know? Not that bad. You know?
Just
don't get fucked up. Yeah. Just don't get retarded. Like,
in the 80s, it wasn't like that. The 80s were cool.
I was about getting fucked up.
No, it was like just no wonder, like honestly, no wonder like my parents or my grandparents were drinking. Oh, you're partying. Like, what? Where's the party at? It's just me drinking a beer. But now I see it. Cause, you know, back in the day, you would party like with four friends and fucking get wasted and throw shit out the window. You know, that still could happen. But I'm just saying, like back in the day when Metallica used to party, I guarantee you. I guarantee you, they were just
spit out the bones. Oh yeah, spit out the bones.
They're just drinking by themselves, and that's their favorite party stories. What do you say?
About the bone trap? What?
He's talking to me. I know what he's talking about.
Okay. Play a.
There's a moonlight.
Oh, wait.
There we go. And that's.
Whiplash!
I see it, Anthony. I see it. That's a good one. That is a good one to play.
I could zoom in here.
That'd be a fun one to play. What's going on here? Oh.
It's just me and you, brother.
Oh, it's just me and you? What?
Yeah, my homie's gonna go to the bar, and I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna keep watching you.
Oh, you gonna go out to the bar? Oh, man.
Nah, dude, I'm...
Are you sure you don't want to go out with him?
There's 1,000 beers in there, dude. I'm good. I'm not really... I mean, I'm a bar guy, but not really. So it's like...
So, Anthony, I am running the Boss Katana Artist 100. That is what I am running.
Dude, right your on. Boss Katana thing, I like your review.
Right there. It's right there. Hey, yeah, I just got out the review for it today, Anthony. It came out earlier today, so yeah.
Can you switch like the color of both of us? Like, can you mess with the contrast?
The only reason why my color does that is it's a lighting thing.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay, because you have a light thing. What do you mean?
Yeah, so sometimes it'll change a little bit orange. Sometimes it's kind of blue. But yeah. Yeah, the Katana.
You have a light coming from this.
Yeah, I got a light coming from right there.
Yeah. I see it now.
I usually have my photography light up and stuff, but it's impossible to put my photography light up.
Yeah, I left my light too. I'm pretty sure you see it.
If I wanted to have the photography light like behind me, yeah, it would work. But I literally can't have it in front of me anymore.
Oh, you're talking about a soft light? Oh, with an umbrella.
Yeah, I can't have my soft light in front of me unless I would get like a small ring light. That's the only way I could probably do it now. Because I have one of, like, the large, stand-up, nice, soft lights.
Yeah. I have you should get this. It's, like, a $75, like, light bar. And it's fucking...
Yeah, my fucking my soft box was less than $30.
Oh, yeah.
And you knew how like really good my lighting used to be in my old studio.
I got like taller sticks.
Did all you drink by me?
I got cheese in there.
Excuse me, everybody. Yeah, the fractal, the axe effects and stuff, all of that looks interesting and stuff like, but it's so damn expensive. You know, multiple thousands of dollars or, you know,
groceries.
Up to $1,000. Boss Katana, you get a nice 1x12 cab with it and stuff, so it's good for live gigs and stuff. Rather than running direct in-house, like, you gotta think about it. Maybe if you're playing a small gig that doesn't have a good PA and stuff, it's still gonna sound good, so.
You spent the stack on it?
Huh?
You spent the stack on it? What did you say you spent
on
though?
Oh, no, he's talking about the... No, so Anthony's talking about how the fractal looks amazing. I didn't spend a rack. I spent $700.
Oh, okay. Dude, that's pretty fucking good, because goddamn it,
yeah,
I was
700,
like...
but it's all... They're all no isolation cabs. Oh, okay. Jamz is using fractal now live on his rig. Yeah, it's just because, you know, lightweight, easy to move, you know, and stuff like that. It's, yeah, you don't have to worry about the cabs. Trust me, when you're getting up to those type of gigs, totally. I get why Jamz Hetfield and stuff like that. Yeah, why they're using the Axe FX and stuff like that. But no, that's what I mean. Like, while I'm still at a like a little bit more small club level, you know, not everywhere is gonna have a good PA. And I want to have a good amp tone. And I want to be able to play real good.
What do you
good.
Think that Jamz uses right now?
Huh?
Do you know what Jamz uses for his rig right now?
Jamz uses a fractal.
Like, all the time.
All the time now. Yeah, it's his normal rig.
Since
he's got
what?
That plus a bunch of effect. Like, he's got all of his normal also.
Because I remember back, like, at least 10 years ago, it was not
They're
a
fractal. Not... Yeah, of course not, and stuff. They also, but they bring their old. They always bring the heads of his and stuff, like all of his heads that he usually uses. They will bring that as a backup.
And do you think Kirk
goes down?
Kirk is using the.
I believe Kirk is using something, but he still uses his pedal board, so he's still going pedal board. So
good, because I think okay. First of all, I think pedals are more. Analog sounding than digital.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's okay. So, what I figured out, what I found out about the Katana series and stuff, it's not a modeling amp, and it's not like a straight, it's a solid state, but it's also a transistor. No, it's not a modeling amp, it's a transistor.
Boss would probably be all of this fucking series in one fucking amp.
But no, the specific, but like the specific Katana series, like even down to like the smallest Boss Katana Mini and stuff, they're not modeling amps. It's a transistor amp. So it's actually using real analog distortion. It's like the distortion that's coming out of it. It's nothing's digitized other than the, you know, your effects, you know, your delay and reverb.
Hey, and is there, but is there an NS2 on that?
Basically. That's kind of what I'm running right now.
That's badass, because I don't hear
anything. Like, I'm running...
Like, you're running that good hot.
Because if I turn off... like, this is without the booster on.
Yeah. What about the... What is it?
What?
With your noise gate, it's good on feedback, too.
I know, exactly, man. Plus, Boss Katana's gonna build the noise gate.
Do you have a... Is there an out to go to a cab?
For the Boss?
Yeah.
Is yeah, like it's got... Yeah, it has the... Yeah, it has 8 ohms. Yeah, it has 8 ohms and 16 ohms. Well, it's plugged into a speaker.
Oh,
remember, it's a 1x12 combo. Yeah, remember, it's a 1x12 combo. Except, don't mind my plates and my pizza.
Yeah.
Just gonna move those out of the way here, out of the camera. Yeah, I'm gonna be a little yellow, sorry. And basically what I have is I have it coming out of the cab right now, but it's also going direct, so you'll probably hear a little bit out of my mic, but it's mainly you're hearing direct tone. And then without the boost I have on it. Can you change the output? Yes, I can. It goes from 0.5, 50, and 100. And the nice thing about the Boss Katana series, at least the 50, 100, and the Artist series and stuff, the output section of it is based off of and is basically mimicking a tube amp, so it gets as loud as a tube amp or just about as loud. Because you flip it up to 50 from 0.5, I'm just using 0.5 right now because you know, it's like 10 o'clock at night and stuff like that, but I use 50 usually during the day, and man, fuck, it's loud.
I'm gonna grab another beer.
All good. But yeah, Anthony, yeah, you can change the power control and stuff. If you want to know a little bit more about the amp and stuff like that, Anthony, go to my channel and stuff. It's the last video I just posted was the Boss Katana like little review I did on this. It's not exactly like a full playthrough demo. I'm not showing everything, but I definitely go over everything the amp has and stuff like that. And it's really nice because it's also hooks up USB to your computer, so that you have more like control and more flexibility and stuff like that with the Boss Tone Studio application. So you can change what different type of booster you want. You can change the types of delay and stuff like that. It's funny. It basically has a built-in metal zone into it. So yeah, that's one of the that's probably one of my favorite things about this amp. It has a built-in metal zone built into it. So I don't go pat. I don't play B and E string on this guitar. I need to do that. Do they sell Internet beer? And yes, they do. I actually had got to try that at NAMM last year and stuff, and it's actually pretty good. Anthony, no, I do my own solo stuff right now. I am working on my EP and stuff like that as we speak. If you want to check out maybe like one of my songs and stuff like that, I have my full collaboration video where I got to do a bunch of solos with a bunch of other YouTubers as well, like Guitar Hack, Stafford's Music Studio, Chicken Guitarist just posted her collaboration on it and stuff. But I'm pretty sure that song's I'm going to probably make it a little bit longer, and, you know, I might get one of the guys that soloed on the collaboration to solo on that song, and that's probably going to be my first single off the EP. So that's what we're going to be looking at. But no, I'm not in a band. I do everything myself. I play guitar and I also play bass. And then I program drums. So I'm not in a band. I'm a one-man show. But I love to play with other people. Like, that's, I love playing with other people. And I love jamming with other people and stuff. I mean, we've been able to do actually a live stream jam before. And that was pretty cool.
Yeah, that was dope, man. I love that shit.
Did you did you go back and check out that like minute mark that I told Fierce to go back to and stuff when we did that? Yeah.
Yeah, I did.
That shit sounded so good. It's just hard to dream the dream of being in a big band. Oh, I know, man. Like you might see my situation right now. You might see where I am. I'm not in like the biggest space. I'm in actually a trailer and stuff like that. But yeah, exactly. It's all about having fun with your mates. It's not, yeah, it's being in a big, like, I could be, if I go around and when I'm talking to people around in my hometown and stuff, it's not a very big town and stuff like that and stuff. Sometimes they think I'm like I'm a big wig and stuff like that because I meet so many people. I go to these large trade show conventions. I run a recording studio and stuff like that, you know. But yeah, it's, but I just, I'm not a big guy, you know. It's, yeah, it's not, I'm not, it, yeah, I'm not running that life. I'm not living that life. It's hard to think that I'm like in anything big, but I love what I'm doing, and that's why I'm never gonna stop. But yeah, to be original is to be something, you know. Yeah, it's hard to be original nowadays, especially in the rock and metal community. I mean, and just music in general, you know, like music really is a thing that just recycles and cycles over and stuff like that. You look back, I mean, rock and roll has been around since the 50s and stuff like that. But if you listen to like the different types of rock and roll and stuff like that, and you've listened to what pop culture has, you got to think about like what was big during the 50s. It was a lot of rock and stuff like that. Then you get to the 60s and 70s and stuff. You're getting more in the psychedelic stuff. And then you get into the 80s, you get rock and metal coming back and stuff. Oh, you don't forget disco. Disco was back there in the 60s and 70s, too. Then you get to the 90s and alternative. Then you get to the 2000s and stuff, and rock kind of makes its way back again. Then you get to the 2010s, and it's more of the pop. And now to today, and it's all the pop and stuff like that. So, yeah. Bring back Stevie Ray Vaughan. Oh, yeah, everyone needs to bring back Stevie Ray Vaughan. We all want them to bring back Stevie Ray Vaughan.
This is exactly what I was getting at earlier. When Metallica did that I Disappear, their fucking solo literally was four notes of Stevie Ray Vaughan.
Like what I was just talking about. Music recycles, man. It cycles and stuff like that. Blues, you know?
I love blues.
Yeah. Especially jazz.
I saw that light.
I mean,
Just move your camera a little bit.
I mean, it's. I want to tilt my camera more, but it's just.
Oh yeah, dude, I love it.
Well, yeah. Well, I was. I'm a bass. That when it comes to blues and stuff like that, or a jazz and stuff, I'm a bass player.
Oh. Did you ever hear the story of, okay, you like jazz music?
Of what?
You like jazz music, right?
I love jazz music and stuff. I even in college, I took a jazz history class and stuff like that.
Did you hear the story about
Art of Noise? Art of Noise is a good man. I love jazz.
Art of Noise?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that like newer jazz or older jazz?
I mean, they're a little bit older than me. They're not super mainstream, but they're actually really good.
Okay.
There was a story about Herbie Hancock, and he was playing with Buddy who was
it? Yeah.
He was playing with somebody that was major and into jazz, and he told them, he said that he was all, they smoked some herbage, and he was just all fucking
sounds like out of guy. It. Oh, no, dude, bro, the jazz guys, oh, yeah, drugs is, like, one of the biggest things in jazz, like, drugs.
He said that he had never really smoked that much, because they were smoking it a lot, uh-huh. and he thought he heard play every, don't play the fifth note, which means you go one, two, you go do, re, mi, fa, and then you go to the next fucking, you don't do the so, you do the do, re, mi, fa, do, re, mi, fa. Yeah, you don't do the so, you go do, re, mi, fa, and then so you hit the la afterwards. So, do, re, mi, fa, la, di, na, 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 na. So I was like, and he goes back down. And he got told this by, I don't even remember who it was somebody more famous. And it literally changed jazz, because he comes back and he goes, what the hell was that? And he goes, you told me not to hit that fifth note, which is to complete the fucking circle of fifths. You told me to skip the note. And he goes, no, I told you to fucking leave that crowd hanging on the fifth note. Huh? And I was like, holy shit. What? Huh? So Herbie Hancock changed jazz after that, for me. Like, after hearing that, I mean, it was Herbie, I'm pretty sure, because it was his story that I was listening to on YouTube. It's on YouTube. He tells it about it.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
I got to find this fucking video.
Well,
I love jazz.
Okay, so, like it says down in the banner down below, I will be right back. I got to grab some ice. My drink is out.
Yeah, you guys, brother, man. We'll be right here. We'll talk about stories.
Entertain the masses like you guys do best.
How you guys doing in the chat? How you guys doing in the chat? Please tell me something. Anthony Hagen, he is in rehab in California. Oh, yeah, we're talking about that. Oh, bring back Steve Reed Vaughan. Yeah, so I just hear a really big Steve Reed Vaughan thing, dude. Like, I'll tell you,
actually a really good guy. I play like musician. Really good. Really good.
I fucking love Stevie Ray Vaughan. Yeah. R.I.P. forever. And Jimmy Ray Vaughan is actually another fucking his brother. Amazing too. But I got a story with Stevie Ray Vaughan.
Do you really? What's it
called? I don't have a story. I'm telling you a story about Stevie Ray Vaughan.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I got told this story when I was touring with the Bon Jovi Body. We stayed with this guy. I think his name, I know his name. His name is Gene, and he had a son that was in some they weren't signed yet, but they were on Victory Records after a while.
Okay.
Skylight bullshit, I don't even know. Anyways, he told me, it was him. He told me that one time he was
at a bar, right, with his friends, and he said that his friend was said, "Oh shit, it's $10 to get in, or $5 or something. We gotta pay to get in." And he goes, "All right, whatever." And he pays, and he goes, "Who's playing tonight?" And the bartender or whatever told him, the venue owner, or you know, the staff told him, Stevie Ray Vaughan, solo guitar player. And he goes, "Well, I hope that guy can play guitar, because goddamn, we have to play to get in." And he said at the exact time, Stevie Ray Vaughan is fucking walking right by him, and he's got a guitar like this. Like, say, okay. He grabbed a guitar, and this is totally what Stevie would do. He had his guitar like this. He walks by, he goes, "Shit." He fucking walked back. And I was like,
"What the fuck?" He did not just grab your guitar and like, "Man, like in a way, and right about way telling you, you can't play."
That he just grabbed his guitar and said,
God.
He said, I hope he could play guitar. And he looked at him and goes, "Shit." Kept on going to the stage.
Wow.
That is the best fucking Stevie Ray Vaughan song I've ever heard in my life, dude.
Jesus Christ, dude. This happened to you.
No, it didn't happen to me. Oh. No, it happened to my friend Gene.
Oh, okay.
That's what I'm saying, dude. I was before, like when Stevie Ray Vaughan died, dude, I was fucking sad. I was a kid. Yeah. You know, I would watch his fucking shit on KRN. Goddamn, because I was fucking poor. We didn't have cable.
So what do you think about Stevie Wonder?
I love Stevie Wonder, dude. Yeah. He was awesome because of Taking Speed. Wait, who? Oh, fucking. hey. It wasn't Speed. It was Crushed Pills.
Crushed Pills.
It might have been.
On my eyes.
It might have been cocaine. I don't know. Stevie Ray Vaughan was on some stuff, man. I'm not saying what it was because I wasn't there for it.
Dude, like,
I'm just gonna say,
like,
I would
say the '60s with the birth of drugs. Yeah, that might have been it. But like, on the rise of drugs was during the '80s. Now, oh my God, now it's horrible. God, like, I can walk down the street and I know probably everybody's on everything. I'm just like, cocaine, meth, ice, weed. He's drunk and about to do some shrooms.
But we're talking about the '80s.
Yeah.
80s was just cool, man. We're like, that's where shit went down, and
yeah.
I feel really fucking. I feel really fortunate now. For you missing that era.
You look at this era now.
I'm right? Pretty close to it.
Dude, yeah, it's
except
almost,
worse.
Yeah, it's almost the '80s. Like it, like there's three things you gotta be doing. All right, weed, to everybody,
coke.
That's close to everybody again. And then you got codeine. You got people smoking weed, drinking, sipping on codeine, and doing cocaine at the same time. It's just like.
And that's just a cycle on how you wake up.
How do y'all fucking do this? Fucking crazy, man. Like, I ain't trying to call it.
Dude, no, all I'm saying is like codeine, back in the day, okay, 10 years ago was Xanax, now it's codeine.
What do you think the Xanax went?
Oh, shit.
In the codeine.
Oh, shit.
What do you think Xanax went?
Now that
you know where we know where we are, you know how popular Xanax is around here.
Dude, I think I fucking people.
You know where
we're getting Xanax. You know where we're getting Xanax. I'm like, no.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
But no, I don't want to fuck with those people. I don't know what
it is. Yeah, you know.
But I'm just saying.
You don't know, but.
Back in the 80s, though, it wasn't like that. It was pure, probably just badass shit. It was not sketchy. And
what I want to know is I'm waiting for it to make another rise because it was short range. But now,
I think we should just get off that subject real quick. Just get off the subject.
Where's mescaline at? Where's mescaline?
Let's get off that subject real quick. So I'll tell you as much.
Who got pure mescaline?
It's funny because it's at the bottom of the screen. Yeah. He just switched.
What? What are you boys talking about?
I just read the fucking thing.
Oh, God. It's so
you know
funny.
What's funny?
Like, I don't know if he even heard us. What we were talking about.
No, he heard us. Funny. He heard us. That's why he came back.
Wait, what?
He heard us.
Wait a minute. I heard you. I kind of heard you. Wait, well, oh, because I'm talking. Oh, were you guys talking about how something's called ice?
No, we're talking. No, we're talking about how the '80s were with how. Okay, why
Stevie our Ray generation?
Vaughan, no, Stevie Ray Vaughan. It was Stevie Ray Vaughan, and yeah. He was on. Somebody said he was on speed, and I was like, no, he was on coke.
And he was kind of talking about crushed up pills. I'm like, oh, that sounds like ice or coke.
No, I said he was on crushed pills.
Yeah, and
he does. Oh, you guys were making. Yeah, that's what I mean. So that's what I mean. So you guys were saying something that because I put down the word because I was going to grab some ice for my drink.
Yeah, and I was just ice. That's all right. We should get off the subject because I just
went into an elaborate story about the 80s.
No, it's not top ice. I'm getting sorry, guys.
But a new
it's from California, but it ain't that fucking bad. Yeah.
We're gonna
make a band as big as AC/DC. Let's do it, dude. Me, you, and my friend Pete Hickson. We'll get together. We'll do it. Me, you, Garguts, and Pete Hickson. We'll all get together.
What, bro? Australia doesn't exist according to YouTube.
What?
No, fucking retard meeting memes? Memes? Is that what it's called?
Oh, you're good, man.
I'm down to go to Australia though. My friends at the pond were in Australia and they said they were sending me pictures of they were getting drunk.
I don't know how I feel about going to Australia just yet. I don't know, is weed legal there yet, Anthony?
Where?
Upside down. Oh yeah, right. Remember, he's on the bottom side of the earth, man. Flat earth, bro.
They have a huge, hey, Anthony, you have a huge, Philippine community, right? Like, deeper inside Australia, right? Like, I've seen, what's it called? What's that dude from Vice that got kicked out? They did Ancient Aliens.
Oh, he's talking about the guy with the
beard. No.
Yeah, the crazy guy who's been there since day one.
No. He. It's from Vice Land. Anyways, it's a hip hop guy.
I have no clue.
Okay, I forgot his name, but if you type in getting high with the
Ancient Aliens. First of all, you just randomly pull that fucking guitar.
Dude, that guitar is fucking.
That is sick looking. I love that fucking color. That is a fucking sick
one. You just got that?
Well, this one's not mine.
Okay.
This one's not my guitar. This one's. Remember, yeah, this is. Yeah.
That's a really good looking.
Yeah, it's a. Well, it's a. It's a it's a Line 6 Variax and stuff. It's a really good live stage guitar. Recording, it's okay, but that's what I got the other guitars for.
Oh, okay.
The live stage, it's great.
Man, that's a really good looking.
No feedback.
Well,
take off the feedback.
Not just that, but
is there in the pickup?
Yeah. Yeah, it's two pickups. I mean, it's a five-way selector switch. But no, the fun thing is it's. The nice thing is the.
Anthony said, not legal, but I'm chopping up now.
I'm able to change tunings just by switching a knob rather than coming up here.
Hey, Anthony.
Not legal, but I'm chopping up now. Oh, all good. Oh, okay, I'll come to your place and we'll be able to smoke. It's all good.
Yeah, I mean, as long as we go there, dude, like, if you can hook it up, fuck it.
As long as you know some of the. But.
Don't see how it's looking. I need that shit.
Again, they're really good looking, man. I like that. That's really good.
Anthony, you want to give us a topic or you want to hop in? And give us a topic? You want to talk about it?
Yeah, give us a topic. Someone give us a topic. That's so we're doing tonight right now. Give us a topic.
The only topic I really have left is probably something that. Okay, I got a good one right here.
What?
Best goddamn metal soundtrack from a movie or video game.
Oh, what?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Best goddamn.
I mean, that's hard.
From a movie or soundtrack or video game.
The only one that comes off the top of my head because it's just all metal would be Metal Gear Rising.
I don't know. Call of Duty's is actually has some good metal tunes in it, man.
I mean, it doesn't have to be video games, but it could be like
anything else.
But video games is a okay.
No,
both,
no, but I'm just saying, like
both subjects. You do both.
Yeah, it could be both. The only one that falls off on is Melvin.
I would say Sonic the Hedgehog is fusion metal.
Anthony, we would talk about that, but that's not.
You gotta go further beyond that.
We don't go into that kind of stuff.
Fusion, they have
we
like,
stay out of the political stuff unless it's weed.
Which Sonic game? Because I played the first one.
Nah, it's after that. It's like fucking.
This is after.
I don't know what's going on with that. I stay out of that, man. I feel you. I don't know what's going on either, to be honest.
We're
music and guitar channel and stuff, so we don't really. I'm not really paying attention to that kind of stuff.
Yo, one guy.
Twisted, a lot of like, to be honest, Grand Theft Auto 5 has got a pretty sweet, obscure metal punk, like, heavy rock station on it.
It's not just that, honestly, like, I found a lot of good bands just off Grand Theft Auto 5, man, honestly, like.
Right, yeah, there's a lot.
I didn't know who Flying Lotus was. I played Grand Theft Auto 5. I loved who Flying Lotus was. I loved the song The Pill. And then, like, 3 months later, I see Flying Lotus live.
Just spit on my fucking face,
there
man.
There you go. There you go.
And then, like, the Hicks. Everyone needs to really listen to the Hicks.
I got another one. Okay.
That's a really good
one. What did I say? Oh, Twisted Metal. Twisted Metal, yes. Another one was... Fuck, I just had it!
No, got no more.
Oh, Tony Hawk.
Oh, Tony Hawk had some good ones.
Any Tony Hawk video game. Only had good fucking music in it.
Tony Hawk always had some good ones. Well, at least the early ones, when they started getting to, like, the later ones past, like, Underground.
Wait, what? Was it Alex or?
When they started getting to the ones past Underground, it was a little... It was not that great.
Yeah, that's true, actually.
Yeah!
Underground ones, I knew we were actually... That's when they were still in the 80s. After all that,
Underground, I just have, like, hip-hop and, like, metal.
Oh, and then let's talk about... What about Guitar Hero and Rock Band? I mean...
Oh, dude,
okay, like,
there's another one.
Actually,
good metal shit.
This was actually screwed up. I don't care who had Xbox or PS3 or PS2 Live, whatever.
Sporadic was my favorite.
But, like, my mom literally got Guitar Hero 3 specifically to play Stairway to Heaven.
Oh, okay.
And that song was not on there.
Oh, what the fuck? Did they advertise that?
They advertised
it. I know that because I have it.
Wait, even Stairway to Heaven?
Do they?
You have to beat it, right? You have to beat it, right?
Where the fuck's my game? Where the fuck's my game?
You told me that Stairway to Heaven is actually on the game.
I think you have to beat it.
Hang on, let me find my game real quick.
When you beat it, the last song you play is...
you have to beat it several times in different
like
ways.
Dragon Force.
I literally fucking just... typed in the code and I got all the shit.
Jesus Christ, even Stairway to Heaven was on?
I think it might have been.
Because if not, that's false advertisement, bro. Like a lot of people actually bought that game.
If not, it might have been
because of Stairway to Heaven.
If not, it might have been the 80s version, which was my favorite version. Holy shit, he's got the whole sandbox! Bro, does the fucking PlayStation 3 work on here?
When I was living in SF, I specifically was like watching Facebook Marketplace and somebody was selling this.
Dude, I need to buy that whole system again, dude.
Boom.
I don't have
PC too?
I still have the game, but the game's all scratched up.
Oh yeah, I don't play both.
I wish the PS4 was that version. At least
the last. Yeah, no, both. I can play Guitar Hero 3 whenever I want again. Guitar Hero 3 was also my favorite too.
Look what I have, PS1.
Hey, this is another game with soundtrack that I love, and I have that. That's my game. Okay. Okay. We'll show it to somebody who looks again.
Nowhere on here on the game I see Stairway to Heaven.
You played it. That,
I think it was, he's talking about the 80s version. Remember the 80s version?
The 80s version sucked, and that also did not have Stairway to Heaven.
That was one of my favorite ones.
It was all right.
Are you sure it wasn't? Right. Are you sure you're not talking about Guitar Hero 1 or 2?
Huh?
You're not talking about Guitar Hero 1 or 2?
Well, see, okay, so Guitar Hero 1 advertised Freebird, and then ironically, in Guitar Hero 2, you got Freebird. So, and they advertised Stairway to Heaven in Guitar Hero 2. So everyone thought they were gonna get it in 3.
Oh, in the commercial.
In Guitar Hero 3, yeah.
Archer. Like, you know how you get those ads before you play the song?
Yeah.
You get those little ads before you play the song. That's why everyone thought. And then, like, my mom went to the GameStop. All right, and she was like, well, I just bought this for Stairway to Heaven. And the guy who was, like, selling the game was like, oh, yeah, you're going to love it. It's in there. So that guy lined them up. So
maybe he got it confused for Rock Band.
I think about it. I mean, those guys. Oh, maybe. Because, yeah, you got, maybe it was Rock Band that had it, though.
Yeah, okay.
Or maybe you could just download it. Oh, tits! With the new one.
By the way,
I didn't even see it. This is what I have for PS1.
Silent Hill.
That's a good soundtrack.
Silent Hill was a better soundtrack,
but I'm just saying. Silent Hill was a better soundtrack. I'm just saying.
Oh, number two.
Number two, it's all right, but like, something about number three.
I've never even played the third one or the second one. I've only played the first one.
Wow. You never played Origins either? You never played any of the other ones?
No.
What about the other ones?
You play Union at all? Like, I don't.
What?
Do you play video games at all? Because I don't. Really.
Play video games at all? Oh, yeah, I do still.
One, two, and three.
No Stairway? Denied, man. No Stairway? Denied.
So it's denied.
Well. AJ, you, I don't want to give away the joke. You give away the joke.
Wayne's World Part 1 when he keeps going to Francesca.
And he's playing the old, what is it, like a seven? Is it really nice Fender Strat? Is what it is.
Almost, I did.
Not that almost. But yeah, dude, I love that. I love that Stairway to Heaven. Or I love it when they fucking go to the diner and it gets on Ed O'Neill and he's like, yeah.
Foxy.
Yeah. And he's like, yeah, it was just one night, one thrill, but I didn't.
Oh, yeah. The fucking waiter guy or the.
Yeah, Ed O'Neill from Al Bundy. And yeah. I was like, bro, I want to hear his fucking story.
Wow. Wow. Oh, God.
I love Wayne's World. I mean, I was on Green Bay's thing and stuff, and he played guitar a little bit and stuff. And he did
today?
It was a night or two ago. So he's on, actually, I think, right now.
He was on earlier today, too.
Oh, he streams multiple times a day.
Yeah,
She'll be mine. Oh, yes, she will be mine. Foxy.
You will be mine.
Bam, yes. I need to learn Foxy Lady.
It wasn't Francesca. It was Francesca was the name of what's her name, right? Neil.
I had to beat them to death with their own shoe. She will be mine. Oh yeah, she will be mine. I had to beat them to death with their own shoes.
When they fucking what do you call it? I'm thinking about part two now. Part two was so goddamn good too. Kind of. When they're going, game, or car, and they fucking continue the fucking game, car.
Game on!
Kids don't know that, man. Kids don't know that today, man. They don't know about playing in the street.
Man, I remember doing that. I've played all the goddamn time, man. Car! We played on the west side or the south. Yeah. We played on the ghetto side. We played with that shit. We would say, drive by! And fucking run behind something.
Oh, fuck. Run, jump in the ditch!
Yeah. Play the rip, man.
See, mine was more, I would be downhill skating or like, cause I wasn't really like a person that'd be like in the skate park doing tricks. I was a street skater that loved doing bombing hills.
I was a street skater and I was like, there's no stairs here. There's no gaps here. Like, it's all fucking pipes.
We have lots of areas. That was the thing that we have a skate park and stuff like that. And then we also, there's lots of things where you can do that and stuff. There are certain places like, yeah, I love to do those kind of things at, but, I was a big, just like, I was a speed downhill guy. So I'd just be I remember just bombing downhills, but I remember literally, I have it on video. I think it's on my old computer and stuff of me riding down a fat hill and there's a car that ends up coming behind me and I just fucking bail off to the side.
So like, you're like what do you call it? A lounge skater.
Yeah, but I just like using a normal skateboard.
That's what's up, man. And now I see these skateboards are electronic, and people are just like standing on them. They're just going
I know, dude. You don't want to get me started down in SF, bro.
I want to. I want to hear your opinion.
Oh well, I think they're pretty cool. I actually had an electric scooter until I got hit by a car.
I mean, yeah, it's cool to have it, but when it fucking dies, can I just put it? Honestly, what it should be, it should be kinetic energy.
With my scooter, you could. I mean, yeah, it wasn't a problem. That was the nice thing with my scooter. It was like if you're going downhill, it kind of charged the battery a little bit.
What it should be though is kinetic energy. You know what that is, right? So motion creates a charge. That's what it should be, like a wheel, like a hamster wheel, but they don't have it there. They disable it, so it's like
not yet.
Kind of like, oh, I have to put this fucking 400-pound thing away just to charge it for like 9 hours, just to go 24 minutes on it.
That was the only. Yeah, no, that was the thing. I hated how long it took to charge for how long I actually got to use it for.
That's what I'm like, dude, I think I'm good on this.
But at least with my, the electric scooter, I was still able to use it as a normal scooter.
Hey, you have an electric scooter?
I used to until I got hit by a car.
Oh my god, dude, I'm so sorry to hear that.
Dude, seriously, like, what the fuck?
Been hit by a car twice in my life. I've been lit on fire. I have almost drowned 3 times. I have been through a lot. I've fallen from, like, 10, 15 feet to straight concrete to my back of my head. Nothing.
Alex, you're a fucking super.
And then I've been also in a car accident, too, as well.
Yo, Brad, you're a fucking superhuman. You're a metahuman, man.
I try to be, man. Smoke the weed, you will live forever. Most of that was before I smoked weed. Actually, the car accident was the only thing that happened. I think, yeah, the car accident is the only thing that happened while I was smoking weed, and I wasn't smoking weed during it. But no, it was just, yeah. All the other things, yeah, that happened when I was like younger, and stuff like that.
That's some crazy ass shit, man. Because I fucking can't believe I wouldn't even. Like, what the fuck? Getting hit by a car twice on a fucking scooter?
Yeah. Well, the scooter. So the scooter also was recently. That was actually when I was living down in San Francisco too.
Was it those Uber scooters or whatever you call it, the Bird?
No. It was one that me and my dad paid for. I paid like $200 for, and stuff.
Oh, you bought it? Okay.
Yeah, like it was my Christmas gift from my family, and stuff.
Okay.
Like both my parents went in on it and stuff, and it was on sale at Target for Black Friday.
Oh shit.
So yeah, it was just something. It wasn't, yeah, it was literally something because I was close enough. I wasn't too far from my school and stuff at the time, from my college. It was just something for me to take from there and back home, really, and stuff. So I was not using Uber as much. But yeah, then I was sick one day, and I was just going. I had a Walgreens right down my hill. Man, a five minute little fucking electric scooter ride. Man, I'm coming back with all my medicine. Like I'm sick as shit too. So I'm just coming back with all my medicine and stuff. And I check both ways, man. I go in the crosswalk, and some dude tries to fucking California roll right there and fucking plow straight into me. If I didn't just jump up onto his car, he would have. Yeah. Oh, no, I don't wear a fucking helmet with that shit.
I'm glad you didn't bust your head open that day. I'm glad.
Chaos Candle, how are you? Oh, I know. No, same. Well, here's the thing. Like, I saw him super last minute, and I basically he wasn't going super fast. He was trying to do the California roll. So, he slowed down. Okay. So, he was maybe going, like,
he's 10 slowing down and stuff.
Yeah, he was hella... Yeah, he was not going super fast. But if I jumped up on his car, and his wheel ate my scooter.
You just literally answered a question of my youth. You call it the California roll? We call it the California roll.
Well, and it's.
And I'm like, where does this originate from? And I've seen.
It comes from California.
There's a movie that.
It's California. No, we it's a fucking. Yeah, but it's also just a thing. It's like we don't stop at stop signs completely.
Dude,
it's true.
No one's
coming. Okay. Especially where I'm at. I live out in like more country and stuff like that, like more back roads and stuff. So like, if no one's coming, yeah, you're gonna slow down to maybe like 2 miles an hour, and then you're gonna keep going.
Yeah, and keep going. I know what you mean, because that's how it is over here too. Like,
it's actually really nice in cities too. And stuff, because then you get through shit way easier.
In residential areas here, that's how it is. You California roll.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then out of the city, you just kind of stop.
Yep.
Keep going.
Chaos Candle, how's your night going?
Oh shit, Chaos Candle.
No, I hope you're having a good night. Oh, you feel like shit? I'm sorry to hear, man.
Oh, what the fuck? Oh, man. Hey, you know, all day today I was feeling like shit because of fucking allergies, man. My allergies were kicking the fuck in since last night. Right now I'm surprised I have not sneezed or blown my nose. I think it's just during the day. Oh, yeah. I'm just fucked up during the day. Done.
Yeah, man, dude, allergies can fuck you up, man. I love doing some clean tones every once in a while.
That's what I'm saying. I haven't heard the fucking review, so it's like I'm tripping out on it right now.
Oh yeah. So you saw the review, and yeah, I did I did some clean tones with it too.
Of course, I saw the review. I got you a notification, so I'm like, oh shit.
To be honest, like I just didn't really do like a crunch tone. That was the thing. It wasn't a full super like demo complete going into it. You know, it was just like a,
you could do it right review, now.
Like, you know. I liked it when I did the Vola like live review of it and stuff, but I feel better. Like it's a little bit better making the actual video, you know what I mean? I just like having our live streams be just, it's a little bit different, you know? It's not just me reviewing shit all the time, you know?
Hurt.
You know, that's like why I love about my channel. It's not like completely tied down to one thing, you know? Like I'm able to do a bunch of different things, you know?
I can't wait to fucking get
it. You have an Ivanez gem, white gold hardware. Ooh, hoo, hoo. That's still what I am on the lookout for, is a white guitar.
I'm in his gym?
God damn!
How the fuck?
Is that the white outline? With the, it was like pearl?
No, I'm keeping watching that.
$8,000?
Damn! Oh, the C-Buy one. Okay. Wait, what? $8,000 C-Buy? What?
Yeah, their gems are super expensive.
Damn.
I mean, my most expensive guitar is right here. It's the Vola. It's $3,000, but... But yeah, a Steve Vai guitar, yeah, it's expensive.
My guitar costed like $500, and I wanted to fucking... Honestly, I went to... When I got it, probably like 2 days later on Musician's Friend, there was a signature 7-string whammy by, I can't remember by what artist, but it was less than my guitar, and it had better pickups.
Oh yeah, the Eclipse, the LTD Eclipses. Oh yeah, those are real nice, to be honest.
It was a 7-string, but it was a signature. I don't know if it was an Eclipse.
Anthony. Anthony has an Eclipse and stuff, and they're like $230 bucks. And he just says he likes it. And I'm just like, oh yeah, the LTD Eclipses are really nice.
And the reason why I didn't want to get this guitar is because it was a signature guitar. I don't want to fucking have somebody's signature sound. I want to fucking make my own sound.
That's fair.
So I opted to pay the $150 or $24 it was more. And I fucking got the Ibanez factory setting. Instead of getting like an LTD 7-string, better pickup, signature guitar with a whammy bar. Like, I should have gotten that, now that I think about it, but I didn't.
Oh. Man, I need to throw this stuff away.
What you got? Oh, your saw?
The plates that I have. Yeah. It's just the plates from it. The paper plates.
And I can't wait to get a fucking little laptop, and I'm gonna be jamming with you now.
I can't wait for it. Your own sound comes from you and your fingers, and your brain, and all of that, man.
It'll probably happen.
It's
kind of like
true.
Wednesday or Thursday. Next week. Tell me a story about
what do you want a horror story of?
When you used to work at a venue. Something crazy. Something so crazy that you have to change names.
That's the thing. Nothing really crazy that I had to change names from.
Oh, okay.
I mean... Yeah, I wasn't. Yeah, like working at that venue, because it wasn't like if I probably worked at like a little bit of a small, like a different type, smaller club more. Yeah, I could see how I could have a little bit more crazy stories and stuff. But no, it was because I used to work for Live Nation and stuff. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yes, Anthony, I can play drums. Not like super awesome, but yeah, no, I can do like basic rock and basic metal. You know.
Yeah. We can. Me and you can probably.
I can do basic 4/4 and stuff like that, and then yeah. You know, I'm working. I remember if I pull out my old drum kit, I have my own drum kit and stuff like that. So you know.
I was gonna say, would you
play my guitar so much more percussive?
You can, if you want, you can hear me playing some drums on my channel, and that's like. Oh, it's that the songs I had sent you that I want you to do the solo.
Oh, yeah?
Do you remember which one?
The one I wanted to do a solo on was Social Media Core.
Oh,
Oh, that's okay. That one I didn't play drums on. I played guitar maybe. I had a friend actually. What I did was I recorded drums how I wanted to sound, and then I had a friend come in with the guitar. He fucking played everything like, and he was a machine, man.
Oh, dude, my old drummer, that was the thing.
Yeah, I just played
that
him
was
like
the thing. So, for my first band. I actually used to play guitar for. I was the rhythm guitar player. And kind of the front man, really. And stuff. And then after our first gig, for some reason, our drummer just kind of disappeared.
What did he do? Get a girlfriend?
No, he just disappeared. Like, he just stopped talking to us. He stopped talking on social media. He had already switched schools for me because this was back in high school and stuff.
Goodbye, old faces.
Is your friend ever gonna want that guitar back?
I don't know.
Okay. You gotta fucking battle the guitar. I hope you fucking watch this channel. You fucking have to use that.
I mean, either way, it's whatever he wants. Cause I mean, he'd rather have it be where it's like he wants me to buy it off of him, basically. But I just don't have the money for that. Cause if I'm gonna buy a guitar that I would buy off of him for this amount,
hey man,
like, I would be telling him you're gonna have to give me a sweet deal.
We're not coming to sugar.
I'm sorry.
Because I'm gonna have to be putting in all the work for it, you know.
Yeah.
Like, I would have to replace the tuners. I probably put a new bridge in it. I probably keep the bridge. The bridge is actually really nice.
Well, let me lock the door real quick.
Okay. But, you know, yeah, if that's the thing. My buddy made me, like, actually pay for the car. I'm like, yeah, you're gonna have to give me kind of a little bit of discount because I might be doing some work to this car.
Well, damn, dude, you're gonna do some work to that car? That's fucking badass, dude.
Yeah, because it definitely needs a new nut. The nut is like cracked and shit like that, and it's just super worn. The tuners aren't meant for fucking this guitar, stuff like that. I'd probably get a different pickup for it because this pickup's a little muddy sounding. So
I really have to use
the restroom, like,
so I'll be right back. I'm sorry, I have to use the restroom.
Are you all good, my dude?
I'll be right back. Like 2 seconds.
You all good? I'll play some crew while you're gone. This guitar needs new strings, baby.
I'm back.
You're back? All good, man. But yeah, I would basically, I guess I would have to get the new nut, I would put in locking tuners. These need locking tuners because it has the trem system, you know. And yeah. I'd get a new pickup for it. Stuff.
Damn, a new pickup.
Probably an EMG, to be honest. Just
go like straight.
No, I'd probably think something just more like the standard EMG. Was the MG
5? What was that fucking pickup that was it a Lawrence Fish? No.
Oh, the Fishman Fluence?
No. The one that Dimebag used. It was a flipped one. Remember?
Oh, that was a DeMar
Lawrence. Super Bill Lawrence. I think it was a Bill Lawrence.
I thought it was a DeMar Super Distortion. Let's find out. We can Google this real quick.
That's not hard Google. Google.
That's not a hard Google at all.
Let's Google in Arnold Schwarzenegger's voice. Okay, Google.
Master Puppets live this year in the rain. It's fucking sick. Sorry, Anthony. Just to let you know, whenever you use the word fucking or something like that in the chat, YouTube doesn't like it. Yeah, Pete says. DiMaggio Dimebucker.
Okay, that's what it eventually became.
Well, I know he had his signature dime at some point, but before that.
Before he got his sponsorships, he was using, I think it was called a Bill Lawrence pickup, and it was flipped. Because that's what I had ordered on fucking Amazon. It's still on my wish list.
First thing.
What was it saying?
And that's when the SH Dimebucker, it's to pick up the dime bag used, and for the first time to pick up the dime bag used, available for the it's great.
You know what? I think Ola might fucking talk about it.
He knows.
Yeah, he would know more about it.
Oh, Dimebag was using a custom one on pickup called the XXL 500.
I swear it was a Bill Lawrence. I gotta look it up. I don't even know if it's called the Lawrence, but I know that I posted about it once, and I just gotta look up my timeline.
I mean, I kind of trust my Australian brother Pete, man. Like,
heard. Pete. But there is more information out there that Pete might have not have heard about. Let me see where I can look it up at. I mean, Australia is pretty far away.
I thought it was the Super Distortion, though. I thought that was DiMaggio's Super Distortion, was it?
Because
it used to be the black and white. It was the black and whites that you would flip.
He would flip them after he was doing the flipped. And it was, I think it was called Bill Lawrence or something. Let me look it up real quick.
No problem. I'll play a little bit of this. Pete, don't know what they started as. Okay, that's fair. I mean, you go back to any of Ola's videos, probably will know.
I mean, it eventually became the Dimebag or something more if you don't know what I mean, Bill Lawrence. I threw it. So. Did you say L500 XL?
Yeah, the XXL 500.
Yeah, that's the same
one
we're talking
about. Is that a Bill Lawrence pickup? Okay.
Yep. That's the one.
Pete says Bill Lawrence sounds familiar.
Yeah, that's the one. And then Fishman. Basically got that same and made it gainier. Mm-hmm. So I was just like, no wonder he would flip it because he wanted more gain. I don't know how that would work, but I guess it sounded more warmer to him.
Well, he wanted more. It was because he wanted more gain. Well, it's because he'd flip it for the neck position. Usually in a neck position, it's usually lower output in most pickups and stuff. So he put a bridge pickup into it and flipped it.
Yeah. That's the fucking genius because he wanted more fucking. He wanted his own sound. And that's what I liked about that. Like that's
exactly.
I mean, honestly, if somebody gave him the BBE, he would have fucking made it even You're a customized zombie beat.
I like the run.
That's the part I don't. That's the part I'm learning right now. Play start Call of Cthulhu on clean with a bit of chorus.
Oh, yes.
I actually do know that one.
I love Call of Cthulhu.
You see, if where is my Chrome?
Actually.
See, I actually have to read the music, so.
Actually, Anthony, have you ever, okay, or yes, Alex, have you?
Sorry.
You do?
That's badass.
What?
Have you ever heard?
Yeah,
I read. Did you read music? I read
bass.
Oh, that's right, because you were in band. I forgot about that.
Oh, shit.
Have you ever heard of, oh, I have shown y'all, what do you call it? What the fuck is this? I showed you that band, Nanowar. Remember that the other day?
Yeah.
And they have a song called Call of Cthulhu. So like I was thinking that now.
Ooh.
I hear that.
That'll be a fun one to learn. I will learn that, Anthony. That would be cool. Ah, man. Yeah, Anthony, I wish you could, man. That'd be awesome. Yeah, Metallica wasn't like the super like biggest band I got into, like a bunch of songs and stuff like that. There was not really a certain band that I really did that to other than Motley Crue, Slipknot.
What,
with,
like, learning it?
Kind of those two bands. Other than that, I learn... What?
With learning the song?
Yeah, like, learning, like, a lot of songs, you know, by, like one band. Like, Motley Crue and Slipknot were, like, the two bands that I kind of, like, learned a bunch of songs of, you know?
Yeah.
So that's like those are like two of my biggest influence, Mick Mars and Mick Thompson and Jim Root and stuff. Those are like my three guitar players right there. Like those are my guys. Like those are who a lot I look up to. But like I love Metallica and I definitely, you know, by like Am I Evil, and that's like the main song I usually play and stuff. And then I play the solo to Fade to Black and stuff. So need that. That part's not exactly
what
right.
What the hell? Why am I saying that?
You all good? You just keep woken up? Did you have a bad dream? Yeah.
I mean, we're kind of just bullshit.
Okay. Don't get me wrong. This guitar is also a full step down. That's also why.
That's true. Plus, that guitar is.
Yeah, this guitar's full step down. This guitar isn't the greatest one to be doing that on and stuff. Like, yeah, this guitar, yeah, exactly. This guitar has to be detuned all the time and stuff, yeah.
Anthony's got,
I mean,
says
yeah,
he's
yeah,
got some chops,
yeah,
chop,
yeah,
so.
You're wrong. Like, Am I Evil, yeah.
Hey, you know what? Man. You know what I'm going to do?
I don't mind Jim Root, man. So easy to dance with two to learn, yeah. Ceiling? I got an idea. Dance on the ceiling? Oh, shit, man. Oh!
Wait. That's awesome. You know it? Oh, shit.
Wait, what?
I thought you were going to play a song called Dance on the Ceiling.
Oh, no, I don't.
Do you know any ZZ Top?
I know LaGrange.
Probably one of my favorite fucking bands ever, dude. In the fucking world.
Oh, dude, I remember I got to see ZZ Top.
Really? What the fuck? What happened?
I've seen ZZ Top live when I was younger. You know. Really good band. My parents have been taking me to concerts since I was like really little. I can't play All Out Life. But here, let me change guitars real quick. I have a better guitar to play. I'll pull this one back out. Better do a bunch of different songs with. I just can't play an E string.
Do you have an A? Huh? Oh, never mind. You can tune that down? Oh, I forgot about that. I forgot about that. So you can...
I wonder why your thing froze up. There it goes.
There it goes.
And I wish this my fucking Allen keys fit in my locking nut so I could.
Dude, okay, that's what I'm saying. You need
Allen wrench.
When you were talking to Sal, when you had that guitar, I was listening to the question. Mm-hmm. I was like, I forgot to mention, because I was thinking of Piss at the time, and I was like, oh shit, I forgot to mention that you need, do you have the Imperial or Metric? Allen wrenches. Because you need Metric, Allen wrenches, for guitars like that.
Probably Imperial ones.
Yeah, and that was my mistake. So,
see, I'm working on the Nero Forte riff.
Oh, that's a good riff, bro. Yeah.
Look up some Slipknot. I can probably look.
Hold on. This thing's like frozen. Out. Here we go.
That's the All Out Life riff. Let's see, I want to hear what this riff is. Ooh, that would be fun to learn. But that would be fun. That would be fun to fucking learn, though. Ooh.
What learn? What riff?
All Out Life by Slipknot.
Oh, yeah.
But, one of my favorite songs played by Slipknot is probably...
Oh,
They fucking spit it out.
Yeah, that one and off that album, I think Prosthetics and Purity were two ones that stood out for me.
Oh, yeah.
They were like later on. Because, I mean, we had the aggressive shit out at the beginning. And then, like, later on, I was like, how can this band, like, shine even more? And that's when, like, the whole other side of the band started taking over, like Sid, Chris, and Clown, and what was the other guy?
Well, it's Sid, guy, Chris, Clown.
Corey. The guy with the spikes was Jim Chris, Ray. Right? The guy with the spikes. Spikes? He was the other fucking, he was a sampler. He is a sampler.
There's Corey. Sid Wilson's the DJ.
Yeah.
Chris Fenn, who's no longer part of the band.
Yeah, not there. He's gone.
Clown.
R.I.P.
Clown. Jim Root.
Jim.
Paul Gray. Joey
Paul Gray gone. Joey Jordison. R.I.P.
R.I.P.
I know he's not dead.
You're alive, but.
Yeah, I know.
Just, yeah.
His career is gone, bro.
Yeah.
Wait, who is it? Wait, okay. Who's the guy with the spiky, the spikes coming out?
I believe that used to be Sid.
Really?
I think so. I don't remember, to be honest. If anyone else knows. I was looking forward to them coming out with Metallica. Right? Yeah, Anthony. Yeah, dude. Like, yeah, since you're in Australia, did you have tickets or something? Because that's they had to postpone their New Zealand and Australian tour. And you're out in Australia. Did you have tickets to the Metallica show?
Are you how much were those tickets? It? How much were those tickets? And are you getting redeemed? Are you getting a fucking, are they coming back? Are you gonna, are
yeah,
you gonna
fucking, refunded.
Are you
I believe I saw
funded.
A thing about being refunded, yeah.
You know, that happened with us with, I tried to go see Rage Against the Machine, and that was they had to refund everybody their shit.
Really?
Yeah, because that was they didn't fucking come out for that tour because they broke up, and I was like, bro, what the fuck? I was like, I want to rage against this machine right now.
Was so excited. I'm a huge fan. Yes, full refund. Yeah, man. I'm Anthony. I'm so sorry to hear that, man. You know, if I had anything really Metallica related, man, I'd be sending it your way, man. But I really don't, other than my blank.
Bro, same here, dude.
Like, if
same
I had
here.
Something by like.
Same
by,
here.
If I had something
hey,
by Kurt
hey,
James or something.
You never know. You never know. There might be a weekly giveaway coming up soon because, you know. I might be
not
able to do
weekly,
that.
But you might see a giveaway coming up here soon.
Monthly.
Well, you're gonna be providing. Are you talking about you? You're gonna be
giving away
something.
Yep, I might be.
On your channel?
Yep.
Nice.
But I mean, of course, you're gonna be a part of it.
Always, man. Same shows going next show at the Perth, Australia. Okay, yeah. Yep. Yeah,
man.
Yeah, stadium shows, yeah, because that's when I saw them, not last time, but the time when I actually got to, like, see them full concert. And so, full stadium.
In a stadium?
Yeah.
Wow.
And then, cause were my
you nosebleeds, or are you
in Australia? You know what, Australia? I'm in Adelaide. Yeah, see, we got two people from Australia in
what?
Our chat.
That's
what
bad.
Are the coincidences? We got two people from Australia watching two Americans talk about music.
That's what's up, man. Hey, it's probably like fucking, you know, that makes sense because it's probably like fucking 6 o'clock over there.
It's about what? Yeah, Pete, what time is it, my Australian brother? Like what? I'm saying like 1:26 p.m. That's what I want to say. 1:26. I want to know if I'm right because I'm, yeah. Oh, shit. Well, new Ola FAQ out.
Oh, shit. I haven't seen that yet. I didn't even see his Nita one yet. Damn it.
Oh, dude, the Nita one's so good, man. Oh,
I need to watch it after
chat. Just go to our Instagram chat, dude. 426. Ah, okay.
Gotcha.
Okay, so I was like, okay, 3 hours off from there, okay.
I said 6 o'clock.
No, not what I mean. I was 3 hours off from what I said.
I was two. Yeah, I win.
I was closest. I know the global clock better than you.
You ever seen, what is it? The other guys with Will Ferrell.
Oh, yeah, dude, I own it.
And Rob Wiggle was like, I'm the winner. Like, yeah. When they get the fight at the funeral.
Yep.
Yo, when The Rock and they gotta make a movie of The Rock and Samuel Jackson and just call it The Guys.
Right. That'd be great.
A prequel. Damn, play some Jamz.
I'm gonna take that from Drop B.
I'm drinking fucking free over here on HTV.
I opened my email and had a letter. I opened it exactly at the time they announced it. I felt like crying. Bro, dude, don't blame you, Anthony. Like, when Metallica cancels a show, it's fucked up. Like, they, and don't get me wrong. Look, I can tell you this. They're mad at themselves, too. You know, no person, when they have to cancel a tour or something, you know, isn't going to be mad at themselves that they had to do it. Like, Ozzy had to cancel a bunch of U.S. dates here and stuff during his farewell tour and stuff and had to postpone them and stuff because he got sick. If you guys remember when Ozzy got sick the most recently and stuff like that, when he got, like, sick with, like, some sort of pneumonia.
I avoided all those articles. I was just like, I'm not going to play into it. I know it's real. But I'm just saying I did not want to read it because I was like,
it was just a thing or more not like, yet. No, I had some friends / coworkers that, were going to that show and stuff down in the Bay Area of SF and they got a refund of it because Ozzy had to postpone.
Oh my God, dude, that's so fucking scary, man.
Yeah. But, you know, but the thing was, is Ozzy felt so horrible, you know, Ozzy felt so bad that he had to fucking postpone his shows. He was so mad.
So is he going to redeem him or is he going to just chill?
Ozzy?
Yeah.
Yeah, he already did.
Oh, he gave everybody his money back?
He already did the refund for one. Like, he did, like, the same exact thing, refund and stuff like that. But then he also, he already rescheduled the whole U.S. tour and stuff like that. He already did it.
I believe. Fuck.
Yeah. The thing is, Ozzy's new album's about to come out.
Hey.
Like.
I just hope Post Malone isn't on it.
I hear that Ozzy never heard who Post Malone was before that,
I don't even listen to that shit at all, dude. So, like, I've not heard it at all.
I just
see the fucking shit
basically
flooded.
If you want to call it a collaboration, it's more of Ozzy does a fucking chorus. Yeah, it's fucking Ozzy does a sample in it. It's like, he sang a line in a song, basically, and then they sampled it to repeat it.
Is like the line sang, Iron like, Man or what?
Here, let's fucking... I don't care.
Let's listen. Just give me the original version. Fuck it. Hey, if you know the original version on guitar, I'll fucking try to guess it.
The original version of what?
Of the song that they sampled it off of.
Is there an original version of it?
Okay, give me the Ozzy, the riffs of the Ozzy song that they sampled the chorus off.
No, they didn't. So, no, they didn't sample, like, something off of it. He came and sang a line or a verse, and then they sampled that, basically.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
So, no, it's completely, I believe, all original and stuff like that. It's called Take What You Want.
This reminds me of the Walk Hard fucking ending.
Welcome to Zombieland.
This new kind of zombie are attracted to the hunt.
And I don't even like zombies.
They are much more afraid of us than we are of them.
She's still alive because zombies eat brains and
comes out October 18th, guys. New Zombieland, at least for US folks.
I mean, we're on the
way. Why is my... No, stop.
Elisa.
I feel you crumble in my arms down to your heart of stone. You bled me dry just like the tears you never show. Why don't you take what you want from me? Take what you need from me? Take what you want to go. Why don't you take what you want from me? Take what you need from me? Take what you want to go.
I so, never needed anything from you.
So this is post the new Post Malone Ozzy, you know. So, you showed post, your tongue don't get me wrong, here's the thing. I actually, Post Malone is, almost believed you. No, yeah, you he's a great, amazing guy. He's actually got some good music. And then, well, it's also just, he's a huge metal rap guy. He actually plays a really good, he's really good at guitar too, you know? Look up video of Post Malone playing guitar. Like, he's an actual musician. Post Malone is kind of one of the rappers I hear that way too. Because he really tries, he's really musical about his stuff, you know?
Well, very good shit like this.
Yeah, like he... Post Malone is a good one. Have you seen the Dewey Cox story? So I see Anthony's not the biggest. So you don't like Ozzy? Are you not an Ozzy voice fan?
I don't know, we can be dead, he says. So where does Ozzy come out of here? At the beginning.
What?
Ozzy's just at the beginning?
No, he comes back up. Right up here. Right here.
I feel you crumble in my arms down to your heart of stone. You bled me dry just like the tears.
That's the same thing. He had to sing one verse. And then he just loves it. Yeah. And oh my god, it's just like all the stuff people were talking about, how like fucking Post Malone made Ozzy big.
Yeah, to the fucking voters.
You see, I believe right here is Post Malone playing guitar. Like, this is Post Malone solo. He's actually a really good, he's really good at guitar, actually.
Yeah, but it sounds like him, too.
Ozzy all night, but I'm old. Yeah, you see, Pete, I love Ozzy. I grew up, you see, Ozzy's really, I love Ozzy. So, like, I'm really sad I never got to see Ozzy and watch that or something like that. When I go to men's times and stuff, it's just, I never had the money or stuff like that. But yeah, that's the Post Malone song, you know.
That's crazy.
Post Malone Ozzy song, like.
What about like your favorite Ozzy song? What's that? Or anything that Ozzy is on at all? Like, not even like Ozzy, you can put Black Sabbath.
My favorite Ozzy song is fucking War Pigs, man. Like, that's just, yeah, I love War Pigs. War Pigs has been my favorite Ozzy Black Sabbath song and stuff like that. That's why I learned it and stuff like that.
I mean, yeah.
That's also. I know that. Yeah, I know the full. That's like one of the songs I really know.
I mean, the whole Paranoid album is amazing. I'll tell you one of my fucking favorite songs.
And Randy it starts Rhodes. Like this. Ozzy doesn't play an instrument. His voice is an instrument. Randy Rhodes grew up on Sabbath, Purple, and like that. Yeah, man. Like, hey. Yeah, that's the thing.
Randy Rhodes. Look, that was Ozzy.
Okay, Anthony. Don't get me wrong. Ozzy is not fucking a singer. Like, he's not Adele. He's not gonna have that clarity of voice. But it's the thing of Ozzy. Yeah, not everyone's gonna like it. But there is a large, as you can tell. I mean, the whole '80s. That, like, you know, fucking Ozzy. Ozzy was clearly people liked his voice. You know. Like, so I understand, yeah, you don't like him, man, it's all good, man, you know? But, yeah, I mean, just because he didn't play an instrument, he still sang, you know? There's still a bunch of amazing singers out there and stuff like that, and stuff that, you know, maybe they don't exactly, people don't find the, like, look, a lot of people don't like Kurt Cobain's voice either, and stuff like that, you know? There's a lot of people that don't like Nirvana, and, like, because of Kurt Cobain, and they think he can't sing, you know?
I think
there's people like me. I love the rasp voice. You know, I love the rasp voice like
no,
that.
No, I'm saying like they had their time in their fucking in the industry, and they fucking set a precedent for.
You see,
what
yeah, that's
did,
the thing.
What they did.
You see, Anthony.
I respect.
If Ozzy came out right now, and no one had ever heard of Ozzy before, no one had heard, like, there was no Black Sabbath, no Ozzy, and Ozzy came out now. Then, yeah, I feel you. Ozzy probably wouldn't be as big as he is and stuff. But he came out right timing, man.
What about Sweet Leaf? You like Sweet Leaf, Ozzy?
Sweet Leaf?
Yeah.
Who's that?
That's that's fucking Black Sabbath. Come on. It's the one starts off.
Oh, the song Sweet Leaf.
Yeah. Boom.
Oh yeah! Oh yeah! It's been a while since I've heard that song. Oh, it's been a while since I've heard that song.
That's one of my favorite ones.
As soon as you like did that, I was just like, "Oh, I hear you." Ozzy sings like Jimmy Barnes from Cold Chisel. Oh yeah,
damn, right for real Jimmy Barnes.
Yeah, exactly. Like yeah, but Randy Rhodes. Oh my God, yeah, Randy. That's okay. So this is the thing. When I was always growing up and stuff, being stuff, my dad's always pushed me musically and stuff like that.
Can you put the chat up on here?
Up on the screen. I mean, yeah. I can do I can do that thing where I do the whole, you know.
Okay. Yeah, do that because I'm looking back and forth like what the fuck. There you go. Jimmy Barnes is sick. Yeah. Okay. What were you saying about Jimmy Barnes?
Ozzy sings like Jimmy Barnes, Cold Chisel. But I was saying, because then Anthony was bringing up Randy Rhodes, you know. I mean, Randy Rhodes. Randy Rhodes is fucking Randy Rhodes. Randy Rhodes is fucking, you know.
Randy Rhodes is
died
man.
Way too early. Oh, I got the hiccups. But.
Yeah. And died in that fucking, it was a plane accident, right? It fucking hit.
Yeah, he died in a plane crash, yeah.
Was he flying in the plane or was he in the trailer?
I believe that he was a passenger in a small flight or something like that. I believe it was a small plane, but
who
yeah.
owned that plane? Ozzy?
Someone, I don't know. I don't know, man. But
I'll tell you something after this. What I think
but
happened?
Yeah, scream in tune and call it singing like Stevie Ray Vaughan. Have you guys heard Jimmy Barnes? I'll look him up. Oh yeah, Jimmy Barnes. Yeah, like Stevie Ray Vaughan. Scream in tune and call it singing. I mean, it's true. But, I remember, like, growing up when my dad would, like, push me musically and stuff when I got into guitar and stuff. My dad would tell me stories about Randy Rhodes and stuff. And he always told me about, like, one of these stories about Ozzy and when he was auditioning bands and stuff like that, you know. Because my dad, he grew up during the whole time, like, you know, that he's the one that showed me Ozzy and Black Sabbath and stuff like that. And he told me, like, he's a lot like me, where he was, like, super into, like, Headbangers Ball, all into the fucking interview type stuff, like, going to shows all the fucking time while he was younger and stuff. Like, so he was around in the scene a lot, and he was a Bay Area guy, so it was like, you know, he was a lot in these type of scenes. And he was telling me about how when, like, Ozzy was auditioning for a guitar player for fucking after Black Sabbath for his stuff, you know, for a solo and stuff, he told me that one of the things that really, really Ozzy drew Randy Rhoads to him and stuff was just how nice and amazing the dude was and how much he loved life and stuff like that, you know?
That's great. So he met him? Like, okay, well, Hetfield is a little Jimmy bit of a Jimmy Barnes.
Hetfield is a little bit of a Jimmy Barnes.
I mean, yeah, I guess so.
Hang on. Right. Hang on, before you get to the story, I'm just going to use the restroom real quick.
Oh, do it up, brother, man. I got you.
You talk to the masses real quick while I go use the bathroom.
I got you, brother.
I got you with 3 minutes. That's 3 minutes of playtime.
I honestly, okay, I can tell you a story. Let's go into story mode. I'm talking about why is it that with Black Sabbath, Ozzy Osbourne, Heaven and Hell, I know it's the same people-ish-esque, because I always figured people get a lot of confusion sometimes because, I mean, Dio did do the fucking Heaven and Hell tour, what, in 2007? And I wish I was there. If anybody that saw Dio, y'all are badass. I never saw Dio, so I definitely got to go see. I have not seen Ozzy. Has anybody seen Ozzy here? I have not. So I feel like I need to go see Oz, and I need to go see, honestly, I see if he does an Ozzy and a fucking Black Sabbath tour, that would be, what if he did both of them at the same time? That would be fucking sick. Then again, he'd probably die on those tours, because goddamn, he'd fucking do double fucking 6 hour fucking what? The headliners, COVID? Nah, he can't do that. That'd be crazy though. What if they like Illuminati powered his way up and fucking got his life back? What if that's what's going on in the backstage? That's crazy shit. Yeah, I know. Dio can sing his fucking. Dude, too much. Yeah, pick it. Okay, Anthony. This is what I was talking about. Alex, I know you're listening right now. Chat, we're talking about best metal soundtracks from movies and video games. So the movie that we didn't actually get to, and I would like Alex to get to this, is actually Pick of Destiny for me. One of the ones. Pick of Destiny had the most damn good soundtrack that I've ever fucking ever come across, because it was all Jack. And if you ever watch The Pick of Destiny and behind the scenes, like, they bring Dio in, and Dio's like such a nice cat. He was a nice dude, nice fuck. And he's like, he was so excited to be recording again. He was like, is that all you have for me? Like, I'm ready to go do more. He was just so like gung ho about it. He was like, let's do more. Let's fucking, I wanna let me harmonize. And that fucking Pick of Destiny is so good, especially Dio's part. But I mean, Jack Black, look, he's an actor more, so he contributes his rhythm, which turns into the bass part. Kyle Gass. He's the more musician of them. He comes up with everything. And they have an actual higher-end musician named, I think his name is Ari. He's in the video when they're doing Master Exploder.
I'm back, baby.
What up, brother?
Oh, yeah, no, I'm with you. I've been listening this whole time. Don't worry. So
I'll yeah, wait. I know. So you think the Tenacious D soundtrack is...
Bro, as soon as you said that, I was like, oh, hands down, yeah, that's so fucking true.
Because I was going to say that earlier.
Probably the best movie soundtrack right there. Yeah, Pick a Destiny and stuff like that. Like, that is the best soundtrack.
Bro, Dave Grohl on drums?
Yeah, Dave Grohl as Satan on drums. And fucking Satan and on guitar. Drum. And guitar.
And guitar. Yeah, he did the solo.
Drums and the solo and part of the solo, yeah, and stuff.
But the behind the musician is that fucking goofy guy on Master Exploder. He's just like this.
Right, yeah. This. No, yeah, that's that was.
The, if you watched the behind
like
the scenes,
one of the best, like, maybe, like, movie, best movie, like, bringing in so many great rock stars, you know?
Did you see it when it came out, or did you see it on DVD?
I saw it later on DVD because I was really young when it came out.
I was, that's true. I saw it when it came out, and of course I was, you know.
Purple was great live. Salvaged with Good Live, of the best live shows outside of the festivals, was easily Status Quo. Or maybe The Who. Oh, yeah, Pete. I could, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, dude, Purple.
One of my, wait. Yeah, you see, like, one of my, to be honest, one of my favorite, like, ZZ Top was totally up there. It was one of my favorite ones. But, I mean, I was kind of young and just kind of watched that from the back and stuff. But one of my favorite, to be honest, is Sammy Hagar and Joe Satriani, bro. Now, that's a fucking show right there. Man, I loved that show. When they meet on the beach? Oh, yeah. And who doesn't? Yeah. And then here's the thing. Like, oh, man. See, Tenacious D is coming to my old work in October.
Wow, really? That's badass, dude. They're coming. I think they're booked soon.
I might go.
I'll tell you this. This is the perfect tour that I would book if I was a manager. They had pool. It would be the openers would be
Top and Back to the Future. Yep.
Oh yeah, yeah. Right? Yeah.
But
it would be.
I have a really great story first. Hang on. For Anthony and stuff, because he was talking about how, you know, he really wants to see Metallica and stuff like that. Well, I remember, my mom's, like, I've grown up, my parents are huge Metallica fans. Like, my parents fucking love Metallica. Like, it's probably, like, my dad's favorite band and stuff is Metallica and stuff. And, yeah, I remember they said that they saw Metallica one time opening up for someone, and they watched them get booed off stage.
Oh, shit.
Yep. So, yeah, my parents have been... Yeah, that's how long my parents have been around to see Metallica and stuff. They watched them get booed off stage and stuff back when people didn't know what the fuck thrash was.
Wow. You know what?
Yeah.
I'll tell you this much. Deftones, Ozfest, 1999, booed off stage.
Oh, yeah,
Satriani
is just fucking brilliant, dude. Yeah, dude, Satriani live? Oh, my God. That is like one of my best memories of fucking someone playing guitar right there.
But I said Deftones got boosted off stage at Ozfest every day in '99. Because Slipknot was after them. Slipknot was.
Deftones is a local. They're a straight local to where we live. Like where I live. I live an hour straight from where they're home based.
Where's this
stuff? Sacramento, California, baby. Yeah. And last year they played Aftershock, which is in Sacramento, California.
Isn't that
where show last year?
Isn't that where Jacoby's from?
Yeah, a couple people are from
Sacramento. Papa Roach, right? Papa Roach.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So
you know, you get a lot of members of bands that are kind of from this area too.
So my homie lived in a cul-de-sac with Jacoby. And my homie was the merch guy for Animosity.
So the Statuani and Brisbane was awesome. Anthony's
and his brother is in Alcatraz/First Blood hardcore band. So I had him stay at the apartment that me and my band were staying at one time. We're watching Scarred because Jacoby was on MTV.
Yeah.
And
Joe Satriani, okay, so, from the '90s. Damn.
So, he's touring with Animosity at the time, and he's their merch guy.
Got a good point, Pete. A lot of good company then. Some great musicians have been booed off stage, usually because they were booked for the wrong kind of show.
That's true.
I'll have to ask my mom who they were seeing when they saw Metallica get booed off stage.
So my homie, we're moving in Animosity's like equipment into the apartment, just stuff that they needed. And then somebody in the fucking band says, "Hey, D-Rock, your homeboy's acting wild on MTV right now." He goes, "Who the fuck is my homeboy on MTV?" He goes, and he sees Jacoby on there. He goes, "Man, that guy's always been weird." And he just walks away. You know, like, oh, God.
That guy's always been weird.
Dude, so he's known him since he was like a fucking 8-year-old kid. They live in the same cul-de-sac. It's crazy.
That's insane. Oh, world class and just fit, fun to play live, great to hear over and over. Oh yeah, dude, Kurt playing Kurt's solos live are really good to hear live. Except when they're covering Prince. Never let Metallica cover Prince. You didn't know they covered Prince?
No, I didn't.
Oh god. Where is my other end of this? It's the only time I will say that. Well, it's half a Metallica. It's Rob Trujillo and Kurt Hammer. Oh, them cover song. It's just a goof, but nah, they shouldn't do that. Nah, you're right, Anthony, but here's the thing. I didn't think it was all that bad. Truly. Like, I didn't think it was the worst. I think it could have been better, yes, but I don't think it was the worst when they covered Prince, you know?
Okay, what'd you say? My bad. What did you say right now?
I was talking about how, like, it's not the worst, to be honest. It could be better, but it's not
Worst. The Metallica fucking soundtrack with the fucking Prodigy fucking VMNT was pretty bad, but I mean, it was all right.
No, yeah, but this is them live. It's in Minnesota. Called Robin Kirk's Doodle. Yeah, because I mean, I saw Whiskey in the Jar when they played Whiskey in the Jar at night before halftime. I thought it was really good. Are you hearing this, AJ? I feel the heat between me and I can just leave me standing. It's not the worst. Maybe I'm just too demanding. Maybe you're just like my father. Maybe you're just like my mother. She never said
anything.
It's so off time.
Why do we scream at each other? Come on! This is what it sounds like!
I mean, you can tell me to turn it up a little bit. Damn, Rob's voice. Yeah, Anthony, yeah. Stomach. Yeah, you see, comes in late there, too, with the vocals. You got the butterflies all tied up.
Don't make me chase you.
You hear the crowd just like, they're just like, what the fuck's going on?
Well, this
would have
been where Prince wrote that song.
You know that Prince lived in Hollywood Studios for a while?
Did he?
Yeah, he lived like 2 weeks and he was working on his last album.
Hmm.
They said he had his bed right there in Studio B.
That's crazy.
And that's it smelled crazy. Like shit. Because all he did was work on his shit. How far is Hollywood Studios from really good?
He definitely
like,
can't hear himself.
6 hours?
Are you talking about Rob? What?
How far is Hollywood Studios from you? Like, good, like 6 hours?
Hollywood is 8 hours for me.
8 hours.
So LA, yeah, LA is 8 hours for me. That's why I fly and stuff. It's about an 8 hour drive and stuff.
I mean, shit.
Yeah, that's why I fly. It's about an hour and a half flight.
I mean, if you had the money for it, fuck it. But I like the road trip.
Well, here's the thing. When you're going from state to state, it gets a little bit more expensive. But since I'm in California still, too,
it's still the same expense.
No. Going from California to California is cheaper.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because I'm not leaving state.
Oh, that makes sense. Because y'all are always, and we're like.
Back. Yeah, and stuff, but then you also got to think about it. You're going to be going over multiple other states too at the same time, so that's also kind of a little bit
from here to where the tip of Texas is probably 10 hours.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, no, Texas is huge. Yeah,
we're used to that shit.
Yeah, no, yeah, that's like, yeah, that's like how long it takes. I think.
I don't know. The traffic ain't that bad. 12
hours go from the top of California to the bottom.
But I'm pretty sure there's a lot of major cities that you have to go through and a lot of traffic sucks.
Yeah, that's the thing. Hell yeah, I did. I mean, I like, well, of course, dude. The fucking, dude, I love Hell Yeah. Come on.
I mean, I love Hell Yeah too, but it's not no Mudvayne.
No, but it's still the same singer, and you still have the voice though, man. You still have that same voice, and that's the big thing about Mudvayne, truly about Mudvayne. If you don't like the voice, you're not going to like Mudvayne, you know? All right, Pete, don't worries, man. You know, I think we're probably going to head on out of here, too. We're all getting up to the 3 hour mark here. You know?
Yeah. We usually do like 3.5 hours. I'm surprised nobody hopped in. I'm surprised like nobody.
I know. Well, it was just, I think Angelo was probably taking care of his girlfriend, which, you know,
well, I know that.
The leg and stuff like that. And then, you know, Fierce was just, you know, he's tired.
He's
we
tired.
Kept him up all week. You know, we kept him up all week until what, like,
dude, 3
a.m., 4 a.m. your guys' time?
Fierce is such a nice dude.
Yeah,
like, he's
you guys
so gotta cool,
go check
dude.
Out, yeah, you guys.
Fierce
please,
is nice.
Check out fucking yeah, Guard Guys. Check out Fierce Metal Dante and check out TF
Snake.
I mean,
TF Snake.
I love, check out TF Snake on Instagram because that's where most of his stuff is at.
Yeah. Because I didn't find him on YouTube, I found him on Instagram.
But yeah, no, yeah, YouTube, he doesn't have anything. Instagram. So where all of this stuff is at for TF Snake. And then me, find me on everything, you know? All my links are down below for Instagram, Facebook, Patreon. You know, I got it all. And you know, when we get up to the, you know, we're coming up on the 200 subscriber mark. We are at, let's see, you know, because I'm lately it's been actually kind of starting, it's been just been going every day. You know, we're at 186 today. And stuff like that. So every day there's just been, you be added a couple more every day. And that's what we've been liking to see and liking to hear and stuff. I've been liking to thank you guys always for hitting that subscribe button, hitting that notification bell so you guys get the notifications when my videos and my live streams come out. You know, don't forget to leave a like button. You know, all that fun stuff that all the random normal YouTubers do, but you know what I like to do? I just like to put something right here so you guys can read. You know, remember, subscribe, hit the like button, comment what you guys like to think on down below, especially in the replays. Always love to hear what you guys think, especially tonight since we're talking about all the Gibson stuff, James Hetfield, and you know, music soundtracks. You know, great movie, video game. What are some of your guys' favorite soundtracks and stuff like that?
That is something that we need. Yeah,
that's definitely something we're gonna go into more too. Just got to do the painkiller thing, and I'll make no sense after like I did anyway. Oh, Pete. Well, you have a good rest of your day/night, my friend. You know, over there in the Australia, have some of that veggie night for me.
I didn't even hear one of the G thought. Like, what's your opinion on like a good metal or like music soundtrack?
Oh, well, yeah, that was the thing. Pick a Destiny is... Once I heard that, I was like, damn, that's a fucking good one. You know what's another really good one? A really obscure movie, too? It's called this movie called Deathgasm.
No, that's a perfect one.
It's got such an amazing, amazing metal fucking soundtrack in it. Like, you want some great brutal metal from fucking shit and some great melodic metal and stuff like that and some...
Yep.
Real good power metal and stuff.
Yep.
It's got it all and stuff. Yep. And it's one of the cheesiest, corniest movies out there, but I think it's hilarious, to be honest. It's fun. It's great.
It's such a good movie, man.
Keep going.
No, I was like, I watched it and I was like, dude, like, this is literally going to be a cult classic forever.
Right? Yeah. No, I fucking loved it. And then Detroit Rock City, of course.
Oh, dude. All kids, bro, hands kiss, down. Hands down. Kiss, though,
stuff like that. Down. Like, it's one of my favorite movies out there. I mean, you have to do it over here. Like, yeah.
If you want to do like stuff like that, like I would say, it was filmed here.
Well, then there's Spinal Tap and stuff like that, you know.
Spinal Tap.
All right, dude. Anthony, yo, see you from down under. See you, James, from up there.
Anthony, no.
Yeah, you have a good rest of your day and night. So have some of that Vegemite for me.
Hey, yeah. Oh, shit.
That's what I'm going to start saying to you and Pete, man. If Anthony and Pete start coming here more often, that's what I'm just going to start saying to them. I can have some of that Vegemite.
Let me get a beer, actually.
I hear that shit's hella gross.
I never had one.
Neither have I. It's like a spread. But it's very, very bitter and very salty. It sounds up my alley. I love bitter and salty, to be honest.
Bitter and salty sounds like beer and peanuts to me. So fuck it.
To be honest, if I ever meet Pete or Anthony, you know, you guys are going to have to show me the good way to eat Vegemite. That's what you guys are going to have to do.
I told them already, show me. Oh, no, I'm going to tell you right now. Show me the way to a Philippine fucking area. Woo! Go.
Let's go! Yeah. Ugh. But yeah, I think we're gonna...
Where's the register? What? Yeah, let's do that. Where's the register?
But yeah, that's... Yeah, it's those three movies. I mean, yeah, then there's... You know, it's a lot of the biopics, you know, have always got some great music and stuff like that. I love the Jimmy
Hendrix biopic.
You put it on fresh bed with butter and not much Vegemite. You see, I think that's where the issue with most people when they put it on bread or anything. I don't think they put butter on it. I think they just put a bunch of Vegemite on. I think that's the issue. So
I never even heard of that, so I would like to try it. Fuck it.
Yeah, you know, I could see, you know, if you get night, that's the thing. That's what I always hear from everyone who's Australian, fresh bread and butter. But every time I see someone eat it, they got a thick thing of it, and it doesn't look like there's any butter. So it's like, okay, got the fresh bread, but I could see the butter helping that, and then, yeah.
I was going to tell you, another good soundtrack, right?
All good.
You know what I mean? You ever seen, okay, it was filmed here in San Antonio between here and Austin.
Okay.
So before like in like New Braunfels, all this bullshit. It's Rick. Do you like Richard Linklater videos?
I've heard of him. Yeah.
He did School of Rock.
Yeah. Oh, well, that's the thing. I was gonna say that. Like you were gonna say so, like your last one. That was gonna be my last movie soundtrack. That's great. School of Rock.
School of Rock.
You can't,
okay.
You can't go wrong with School of Rock soundtrack.
So no, but it wasn't filmed here. I'm talking about Dazed and Confused.
Oh yeah. Okay. Yep.
Okay, so that's what I'm talking about. But School of Rock is amazing too. And I saw that kid got recently busted for fucking stealing the guitar.
Did he?
Yeah. The you ain't hardcore.
Yeah.
Until you rock and fucking roll.
Yeah.
Yeah. He ain't hardcore too.
You ain't hardcore till you buy a steal a guitar. You ain't hardcore till you steal a guitar.
Dude, you need to like start clipping fucking shit you say and like play it back. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you mean every time usually when I like sing or something like that? Like when I did the
You need a virtual sample board and just hit it. You know what I'm saying? When the fucking,
I know.
When it gets low.
Oh, yeah. That would be. You just get fucking little. You get a little sampler and stuff like that connected to my mixer.
You can do it on a bunch of fucking programs on the computer. Now.
That's true.
Yeah,
yeah,
like,
but I would rather have the nice thing where I'd actually hit a button.
I know what you mean.
Like, no, it wouldn't even have to be like a it would just have to be like one of those like super cheap drum pads, you know?
And like,
and
easily,
then you just set up all the buttons.
So you can record it real quick, like in 10. You'd be like, it's easy to record right now. Bam, bam.
Exactly.
Okay, this is it.
Then you set it to that just that drum pad and stuff. And then you press that drum pad and it says that. Man, now I wish I didn't get rid of my old keyboard.
you do a digital one and just move the knob and it'll fucking move pages infinitely.
Yep.
And there'll be two buttons, three buttons.
All right, buddy. Well, everyone's on out here.
Close it out, brother, if you want to do it. I'm out of here, man. If you want to get out of here, I'll be around afterwards if you want to chat.
Yes, always, man.
Okay.
To chat up for a little bit.
All right. Me too. So. And
I gotta finish my drink and stuff like that. So
I'll sit here and chat
for a little bit.
I'll say this. Can I promote something real quick?
Promote it up, my friend. You're always welcome to promote stuff on my channel. You are like, I gotta say, you've always been like my number one support, one of my number one supporters. You've always been great having you on the channel and stuff. You are like my man when
same
it comes.
Here.
You're my
same
second
here,
man
bro.
When it comes to this
same
show
here.
And stuff. So,
same
you know,
here.
Like,
same here.
I don't even like going live streaming without you, my friend. So it's
same
like,
here, dude. Same here. I mean, I do it, but I'm like, fuck.
Yeah, I'll do
weird.
It. Yeah, I'll do it, but it's like, now I'm just talking to myself. I could be talking to AJ.
Yeah, I go off with the stories and shit. But okay, so. I got a show coming up in Austin. And if anybody wants to hang out in Austin and fucking meet up or whatever, if anybody's listening, I'm pretty sure not, but I want to get some Austin fucking fans.
Austin, Texas.
Austin, Texas,
baby.
And that's going to be next Thursday. And we're going to be...
Where's it going to be at and what time?
You know what? I'm going to have to fucking get... I'm going to have to post it down and below because I don't know it right now. I literally forgot the fucking name of the venue. I'm not from Austin, so it's like the Austin venues that we always play at are fucking always a mess. But I mean, if we do another live stream, I can fucking promote that because we got till Thursday.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna live stream again tomorrow probably.
Then perfect. I'll have the information out there. But playing bass and a band. Down there, and I'll let y'all know the fucking info, but it's a band called Swan Lane, and it's just literally a hardcore, old school hardcore band vibe with,
oh,
like,
sweet.
New New School Vibes.
Swan Lane?
Yeah.
All right, band's called Swan Lane. They're going to be playing in Austin, Texas. We'll give you an update on what time and what venue it's going to be asked, but if you are any friends next that are coming Thursday. Out to the Austin, Texas area this next Thursday. Thursday, come out and see our buddy Gargus play out with Swan Lane. They're an old-school hardcore band, and they're going to be hearing it, and they're going to be playing it up. So we'll let you know the venue, and I'll give you a nice good update on when that can come. So, Gargus, AJ, my buddy, thank you for coming out, my friend.
Thank you for having me, brother, man.
Well, let's talk out. We're going to talk afterwards, like always.
Yeah. Close it out, brother.
All right. Thank you, my buddy.
Who's going to be? Woo! You stay.
I was like kind of a little early. You know, that's the thing about StreamYards. It's actually pretty snappy. Usually I'm used to something that's going to maybe take a second to like close out of him. My bad, AJ. But yeah, so tonight was a super fun night. We talked about Gibson and we had some great people and had their opinions on stuff. And yeah, we just think it's going to be like, it's the speculation. We're hoping their video is going to come back and they're going to do something. You know, it's not just their videos are all gone and stuff. I think that they're going to be coming out and they're going to be copywriting most of their music that's going to be coming out on and had on those videos. So then people don't have the authority to republish and re-upload the videos to their own channel and stuff and start making money off of it and stuff because of like what happened with the Play Authentic video where they took it off and then, you know, a bunch of YouTubers and a bunch of stuff were just like, well, we have the video right here. We've had it since, you know, we knew that this was going to happen when this happened, so we downloaded this video and stuff because we're not going to let you off the hook, which is something that's true. They shouldn't be left off the hook for that video of Play Authentic. I mean, yeah, and then after they sent out the Play Authentic thing, they went after Dean Guitars and stuff. So it was it's that whole ordeal starting to come back. You know, I'm pretty sure, yeah, it's just Gibson wanting attention, Gibson doing their thing, stuff like that. But yeah, and then we also talk about Jamz Hetfield and Metallica postponing their tour and stuff like that. It's sad to see, you know, Jamz going back into rehab, but we do wish him the best of luck and we do wish him, you know, him getting the best of recovery and all of that. So, you know, to be honest, I know it's sad to say, but to you, Jamz, we cheer one out to you. But yeah, sorry that you got to go to rehab back to it, man. We wish you the best of luck. And then, you know, we're always shooting the shit and talking about music soundtracks that are best, you know, best music soundtrack for video games, movies, and stuff like that. So, you know. So, you guys, thank you all for coming out. Thank you all. You know, you all have been wonderful. I am so happy. Thank you for my subscribers. We're coming up for the 200 subscriber count. Coming up here close. We're at 186 right now. 14 away from 200. And at 200, I think I'm going to come out with probably some sort of merch. Maybe a shirt that you guys would like to see on the channel, you know. So once that we hit that 200 subscriber, maybe you'll see something come out. So this has been Alex from Effort Studios. Hope you guys have a wonderful night. Keep the positivity going in the gear community. Later, world.